Number 17, Evan Roper. Batting fourth, playing left field, number 34, Logan McCray. Batting fifth for the College of Charleston, playing third base, number 2, Tommy Richards. Batting sixth, playing right field, number 3, Bradley Dixon. Batting seventh, the catcher, number 9, Danny Woodruff. Batting eighth for Charleston, playing first base, number 11, Ari Sekopoulos. And batting ninth, playing center field, number 25, Luke Morgan. This afternoon's starting pitcher for the College of Charleston is the right-hander, number 13, Griffin McClarty. The head coach for the Cougars is Matt Heath, assisted by Jeff Whitfield, Austin Morgan, and Ryan Jenkins.
Cast it near I-10. They're on Edgewood at the corner of Beaver and Edgewood, and their website, First Coast Auto. That's the number one, stcoastauto.com. Go tell my guy, Guy Marvin, that Hacker sent you to the auto and credit experts. My friends at First Coast Auto Sales.
Hi, this is Joe Butler at Black Creek Outfitters, your hometown outdoor store. Our store is second to none. Not only are they great in-store, they go out and hike, bike, paddle, fish, ski, sail, surf, camp, trek, and travel. With all this real-world knowledge, they ensure that your experience will be the best it can be. Black Creek has wide selections from Patagonia, Hobie, Outdoor Research, Molokai, and Osprey. Now is the time to shop and buy locally at Black Creek Outfitters.
If your vehicle's AC isn't as cold as it used to be, O'Reilly Auto Parts can help. Pick up a can of InterDynamics R134A refrigerant on sale for $29.99. Plus, earn double O rewards points on your purchase. The gauge and hose are included to make recharging your vehicle's AC system as easy as 1, 2, 3. Just connect the hose to the low-pressure port, measure the system with the gauge, and squeeze the trigger to start charging. InterDynamics replaces lost refrigerant and oil while sealing most leaks in AC hoses, gaskets, and O-rings. Get cold air back into your vehicle now with InterDynamics R134A refrigerant. Here's the voice of the Ospreys, Richard Miller.
Second game of this home-and-home series pushed back a day due to those heavy rains Monday night and into Tuesday. And everybody stay safe up in Middle South Georgia. I see tornado warnings and such. It's a rematch of the Ospreys' 11-2 win at College of Charleston back on March 14th as North Florida hosts them. And this is actually the first year these two teams have ever played. The Cougars, they come off a three-game weekend sweep of the CAA preseason favorite, a team the Ospreys played last year in UNC Wilmington. So the Cougars playing good baseball. They won all three of those. They've won five straight in conference play. UNF took two of the last three against Kennesaw State, as they have not lost a weekend series in 2017. We'll have a couple of freshman arms out there today, both righties. For the Ospreys, it'll be Cooper Bradford, as he is 1-0 this year, and Bradford also an ERA of 1.66, as he's playing good baseball. His 10th appearance of the year, as he has only given up four earned runs this season. On the other side, for College of Charleston, the Cougars will go top of the order with Luke Manzo, number one, their shortstop. Second baseman Dupree Hart, who is really, really good. All CAA preseason, also a freshman All-American last year. And batting third is Irvin Roper, as Roper DH. And batting cleanup might see him in the first inning. It's their best player, Logan McRae, the left fielder. Here's Bradford. He'll wind up, and we'll start things off at 3:01 p.m. on a Wednesday afternoon. There was a little puddle or so out in left center field, but that was about it. Maybe could have played yesterday, but tough making that four-hour drive. The 0-1 pitch and outside, 1-1 here to Manzo. For Luke Manzo, very young team for College of Charleston. They only start one senior. It's behind the plate with Roper. Today, the DH, the 1-1 coming from Bradford. Here's Manzo, popped up. It'll be in foul territory, just slightly. Left fielder Wes Weeks will make the fly ball catch there in left. For the Ospreys defensively, Blake Voyles behind the plate. First baseman, Christian Diaz. Second base is Mac Wilson for his fifth straight start. Over at shortstop, as always, every game this year, it's been Patrick Irvin. Third baseman, Alex Merritt, left field again. Wes Weeks in his 23rd start. Straightaway center is Chris Thibodeau, 29th start of the year. Yair Garolin, right field. And here's Dupree Hart. He'll show bunt, take a strike there from Cooper Bradford. As the first matchup between these two teams, we saw a lot of pitchers, 12 in total. The Ospreys had five toe in the rubber that game. Here's Bradford, the 0-1 pitch. Dupree Hart takes one low and inside. So one ball, one strike, like the first at-bat for Manzo. And Hart had three runs on Sunday against UNC Wilmington. The 1-1 pitch from Bradford, and that one into center field as Chris Thibodeau will back up, and that'll be gloved by one of, I believe, two Canadians we have in the starting lineups, is their first baseman for College of Charleston from Ontario. So a couple of fly balls early here for Cooper Bradford, who's been pretty reliable in going about maybe 60 pitches and usually about four innings of work, as he's only allowed three runs over his last 15 innings. And here's Irvin Roper, and he takes a strike for the lefty bat. Over 100 starts in his career. Honorable mention, all CAA. He's not going to be the best catcher in the league when you've got Nick Fite at UNC Wilmington. That dude is a beast. We saw him last year, and man, RBI home run machine. Yo, one, you're a Roper. Outside there again. One ball, one strike. With two outs in the top of the first, College of Charleston in town facing University of North Florida. Both teams off to very good starts in conference play. The 1-1 pitch, and here's Roper fouled off. He'll line that one and just miss one of the light fixtures. As a sunny day, you talk about, man, it's only April 5th. It feels like it is July 5th in certain parts. If you're not in the shade, if you're out in the sun, and you don't have any breeze, whew. 1-2 coming here for Roper, and that one gets him on the high and outside. And what a start here for Cooper Bradford. The K to end in 1-2-3 That's pretty nice, retiring three straight, and what a way to start the game. We'll move to Pat Irvin, Chris Thibodeau, and Yair Garola to go to the bottom of the first. 0-0, College of Charleston visiting North Florida. It's UNF Baseball on 1010XL.
Hey.
Gets a start on a weekday, as he did see some action in the first meeting against College of Charleston. We're in the bottom of the first as Cooper Bradford, 10 pitches and a couple of fly balls here early on. On the other side of things, it'll be another freshman as he'll go Griffin McLarty, and very good his senior year of high school. Man, 11-0 record and ERA of 0.30. Yeah, 6-3 and a buck 85. For number 13. Just his third time this year, though, pitching away from home. So we'll see how he does. He did throw on Sunday, though, throwing a couple of innings against UNC Wilmington. Two innings of work, 25 pitches, struck out two, no hits, no runs. So a nice couple of innings in the sixth and the seventh on Sunday. The Ospreys, 20-11. They've won back-to-back games here at home. It seems like they've been at home for quite some time. They'll head out on the road this weekend. They'll leave, I believe, sometime on Thursday, as they have Lipscomb on the road. So that's going to be a big matchup. And Pat Irvin is up to bat for UNF. It'll be Irvin, Thibodeau, and Garola in the bottom of the first. As it's a beautiful day, but I can tell you this much. We got a new air conditioning unit in the press box. It's not perfect, but it's wonderful. Because very few things are perfect in life. Pat Irvin, man, he's been good. 6-10 against Kennesaw State. Went 2-6 with a couple of ribbies against College of Charleston. He'll lead things off for the Ospreys. A good BP session. Ripped a few down the right field line. Starts off with the strike for McLarty. As McLarty, just a big dude, going to try and throw as many strikes as he can. That's pretty obvious. The Ospreys had a lot of hits. Every starter had hit against the Cougars the first time. Yo, one, that one over to first, diving out. Nice play by Sakopoulos, and he'll dump off to his starting pitcher to ground ball there. Is Patrick Irvin actually had a few of those that I know you put up kind of the fencing for the fielders at first and second during BP, but Irvin had a nice batting practice go-around. Here's Chris Thibodeau for North Florida. As Thibodeau has been really good on base safely in 19 straight games, hitting .327 for the Ospreys. And three hits and three runs over the weekend. So he's been solid for the Ospreys center fielder. Hide away for a ball from McLarty. On deck for the Ospreys is Yair Garola. Second best slugging percentage in the A-Sun, and he's just been doing a little bit of everything for number 20. With one out, the 1-0 pitch from McLarty, and that one popped up to center field. That one back at the wall. That one is gone, and that one, it looked like it hit a passing car as Chris Thibodeau goes 400 feet plus. My goodness, as that one's back in the forest for Chris Thibodeau. So number 15, that is home run number 5 of the year. And that is now 20 straight games that he has reached base safely. And that one was actually, I don't know if that was wind-aided at all. Oh, my goodness. Thibodeau makes it look so easy sometimes and the Ospreys jump out to a 1-0 lead. Hey, here's Yair Garola inside of the plate, misses for a ball. And Oz getting ready for the home run call for Garola because he's got 6 dingers and 30 RBI. He's got a chance to beat Corbin Olmstead's 59 from last year. The 1-0 pitch, and McLarty finds himself a strike. Garola the first time against the Cougars went 2-for-5. It's a good all-round game as McLarty stares in and tries to shake off that home run. The 1-1 pitch, and that one misses. Home plate umpire today, Randy Olhausen. Over at first, Jeff Gosney, and third base umpire is Vic Correll. Alex Merritt, the cleanup man, is on deck, and he has been stellar also. Trying to make it a 10-game hit streak with the hit today for number 4, the 2-1. And doesn't swing as Garola, great plate presence, as he has 3 balls and 1 strike. He's walked 9 times this year. On-base percentage of .380. So McLarty stares in. Not quite those couple of innings he had on Sunday. Thibodeau makes him pay. The 3-1 pitch, and that one a big cut as Garola was going for that left field line. College of Charleston, a very good program. 15 consecutive years where they've had 30 or more wins. I mean, there are very few schools that you can say that they've gone 15 consecutive. The full count pitch, here's Garola, fouls it off, and that'll be back towards the UNF Fieldhouse. Hopefully it's not like Saturday where we had, I mean, there were probably 4 or 5 vehicles that were victims over the weekend. That was tough. I'm sure insurance companies were called plenty on Monday. Probably just 8-6, you think? Phone lines open. 3 balls and 2 strikes. Here's Garola. He swings and a fastball high and a strikeout. The Ospreys against Kennesaw State did do well when the count was full. And Alex Merritt up for the Ospreys as we get the Friends theme song and North Florida with the 1-0 lead over College of Charleston. Merritt batting average is top 5 in the league at .352. The reigning A-Sun player of the week. 8 hits last week, reaching base in all 5 games. Here's Merritt, a strike for the third baseman. So Merritt this year is kind of split about equally. He and Joe Boyle have shared duties over third base, and Merritt from time to time, say if Diaz gets a DH role, Merritt will move over to first. The 0-1 pitch from McLarty. That one inside, and Merritt's going to drill that one to center. Is that one's going to drop for a base hit, and the Ospreys, and Merritt thought about heading to second and testing the arm of Luke Morgan, and Alex Merritt's going to stay on first. So Alex Merritt with a base hit as he's got 45 now on the year. As you've got Pat Irvin, Yair Garola, and Alex Merritt all with 40-plus hits for the Ospreys, and UNF with the pair already so far. So Merritt, a great weekend. That's now 10 games in a row he's had a hit, as he's now had 2 separate hit streaks of 10 games each. And here's Chris Berry, the DH. The lefty bat takes a ball inside. Saw him head to the locker room on his longboard today, donning a Tampa Bay Lightning ball cap. I always forget how much of a hockey fan he is. But he is a diehard for Berry. He's been on base 18 straight games. Had a rest on Sunday. As McLarty checks at first, getting back is Alex Merritt. No batting gloves today, so I'm assuming that the blister healed. Had one on the inside, I believe, of the right pinky. And then outside, I think, of the left middle finger. 1 ball, no strikes. McLarty stares on in, trying to get his first win of the year. The 1-0 pitch, and Berry, he'll just kind of drop that one over the head of the third baseman, Tommy Richter. And my goodness, Chris Berry, he is going to find a way to get it on base as North Florida with back-to-back singles. So the Ospreys are trying to get out ahead early. Thibodeau started things off with a solo home run to straightaway center, as I'm pretty sure it hit that maybe Subaru. Is it a Subaru Tiburon? Is that what it is? I think it was a Tiburon. So the Ospreys with two men on and two outs, and here's what's Weeks. One for five, a couple of runs and a walk the first time against the Cougars. For Weeks, a left fielder, the righty bat takes a strike from McLarty. As Weeks, also a nice game on Sunday, had a double rip down the left field line. Also had a couple of runs scored. So Weeks gets settled in. With two men on with back-to-back singles from Merritt and Berry. The 0-1 delivery, McLarty. That one missing low. Also the infield right now, starters with Dupree Hart at second. He turned a triple play, just the second time in program history for College of Charleston. And also one of the coaches telling me it could have gone unassisted. Luke Manzo at shortstop as both he and Richter try to make that play on just a well-placed ball by Chris Berry. Outfield left to right for the Cougars. It's McRae, Morgan, and Dixon. McLarty stares in with Wes Weeks, a count 1-1. Dupree Hart's going to move back a little bit. If you remember also from Sunday, Weeks, as he takes a ball there outside, 2-1 the count, Weeks actually showed bunt against Kennesaw State and then immediately pulled back and jacked it down the left field line. That got him a couple of bags as Weeks hitting 258 this year. McLarty looks back at second. The 2-1 pitch, that one inside, 2-2. Nice strike there from McLarty. Also, a connection here is Smoke Laval, the assistant at LSU, when at the time Matt Heath was becoming an All-American for the LSU Tigers. 98-02. The 2-2 count. Here's McLarty. Swings and misses, and Weeks looks back. Yes, it's in his glove, as Danny Wondrak shows that to the home plate umpire. So the Ospreys with three hits. It's a solo home run from Chris Thibodeau to give the Ospreys a 1-0 lead. We head to the top of the second as the Ospreys a lead here. Coming back, it'll be Logan McRae, Tommy Richter, and Bradley Dixon for College of Charleston right here at Harmon Stadium. You're listening to UNF Baseball on 1010XL. XL, or maybe checking out our live stream here today. So we appreciate you tuning in on a Wednesday game after it was supposed to be yesterday at 4 o'clock, but we get you today at 3 o'clock. And Cooper Bradford on the mound for the Ospreys. Top of the second with UNF leading 1-0 over College of Charleston. Logan McRae takes the strike. McRae definitely their best player. Pretty easy when you look at 8 home runs, 31 RBI, which leads the CAA. 5 runs knocked in on Friday last week and slugging .667. The 0-1 pitch from Bradford. A little outside, probably a little high also for ball 1-1. The Osprey infield, Diaz at first. Mac Wilson started second. Shortstop is Irvin. Third base, Alex Merritt. The 1-1 pitch, McRae. He'll pop it up. It'll get out of the infield. Wilson backing up, and he'll snag that one as we get a nice little breeze here. Pushing from more of that south-southwest and out to the ocean, making the trees sway a little bit. And to start things off, Bradford has retired all 4 Cougars. 3 fly balls, and here's Tommy Richter. He comes from a baseball family. As Richter this year, the junior hitting 342, Radford the windup, righty versus a lefty. Boyles kind of bobbled that behind the plate. We get a ball to Richter. Richter, 18 games straight. He has reached base safely. Hits an 8 of his last 9. The 1-0 pitch outside, and there's a strike there. Beautiful by Cooper Bradford. So the Ospreys showing early that they're capable of some hits right out of the gate. 3 today. They're 6th in the NCAA for hits. And there's a hit for College of Charleston as they're on base, and Tommy Richter heads over to first with a single. So Richter now 19 in a row that he's been on base safely, and that's pretty nice. Again, Richter, let's see, his oldest brother played at Delaware, his second oldest played at Penn State, and also, ironically enough, last year against the Blue Hens, he went 5-for-5. So I'm sure that was some brotherly love discussion over Thanksgiving dinner. Here's Bradley Dixon. He hit his 11th double on Sunday, so he's kind of like their Yair Gurriela. He's going to find the gaps here for Dixon this season, hitting 290, 18 runs knocked in. Go over to first is Bradford, as it's turned into a nice day. Some cloud coverage cuts down on that heat. It's a little breeze. Well, it's not. You still need the SPF probably 35 or 40. And here's a pitch well inside, almost around the knuckles of Dixon. As he also had a little streak of reaching safely. As Dixon ended last year reaching on base 17 in a row. One ball, no strikes. Aaron Bradford, the pitch to Dixon. That one will be chopped foul down the third baseline. We'll get a new baseball for Cooper Bradford. One ball, one strike with one out and a man on after a single over to left field, Tommy Richter. I'd say my favorite Richter is Andy Richter. He's a very good guest, cohort of Conan O'Brien. One ball, one strike here at Harmon Stadium. Gorgeous day as Dixon trying to continue his decent year thus far. Against Hofstra, very rarely does this happen. Game-tying hit and game-winning hit. The 1-1 pitch, and Dixon, that one will be just over the glove of the shortstop, Pat Irvin. And much like the Ospreys in the last frame, when it was Merritt and Berry, the Cougars get a couple of back-to-back singles. So Richter on second, Bradley Dixon at first, and here's a catcher, Danny Wondrak. So Wondrak started at catcher in that first game against the Ospreys, won 1-for-3 in a run, as he's the 7th bat in the lineup. Righty bat with a nice opportunity, as Wondrak with 3 home runs, 17 runs knocked in. As they go maroon tops and white numbers for College of Charleston. Bradford the pitch, and that one will be to center field. Trying to dig for that one. It's going to drop in a shallow left center. Trying to get the scoop, and it was Weeks coming over to help Chris Thibodeau, and we'll keep the runner over at third, but definitely Smart with just one out. And load the bases. So 3 straight hits for the Cougars. And they've gotten into a nice little rhythm here as first baseman Ari Sakopoulos, as one of their youngsters in the lineup. Very good. Big guy. I mean, stands out immediately at 6'4", 220. As Bradford clears around some clay near the rubber, gets his back right foot set with one out, and the base is full for the Cougars. And the Ospreys lead 1-0. We're in the top of the second here at Harmon Stadium. Here's Sakopoulos. Takes one low and almost breaking away from the glove of Voiles. As, remember, 12 pitchers combined for that first matchup, so the pen could be very active today. As it looks like Matt Vaca is the first arm for UNF, getting some work out there, number 18, the junior. One ball, no strikes. Sakopoulos, the lefty bat, he'll swing, and he'll pop that one up high. That one back towards the wall, that one back and gone as that one hits the road. And that'll be a grand slam for College of Charleston. as that is four consecutive hits, and Ari Sakopoulos, wowzer, the freshman, his first career home run. What a way to do that in style right there. As Sakopoulos, number 11, he makes it a 4-1 ball game. So Sakopoulos kind of does exactly what Christian Diaz did in the first meeting. Diaz had a grand slam back on March 14th. So College of Charleston says, you got the lead for a little bit. We'll take it right back and add some more. Here's Luke Morgan. Took a ball there from Bradford. The 1-0 pitch from number 7. Swings and misses as that one broke on down. Got a little piece, did Morgan. Now 1-1. Morgan, just a little time against UNF in the first meeting as he was a pinch hitter. The 1-1 coming. Morgan, that took a little hop in front of Oils as pitching coach Brent McNeil takes a little stroll out to the bullpen. And it looks like there are maybe a couple of joggers that might get those baseballs of two home runs already. The 2-1 pitch, and that one will be a hard liner to shortstop Pat Irvin. A nice throw on point. And so they retire Luke Morgan for just the Ospreys' first ground ball defensively of the game. And here's another bat. It's the 7th of this frame for College of Charleston. And it's leadoff man Luke Manzo. Manzo, the sophomore, 365 batting average, 3 hits the first time, and a top 5 hitter in the Colonial Athletic Association. 2 outs in the top of the 2nd, Bradford high there for a ball. So he retired 4 straight, then gave up 4 consecutive hits, 3 singles, loaded the bases, and then Ari Sakopoulos to deep right center for a grand slam. On a low and away, now 2-0, the count to Luke Manzo. For Manzo, the shortstop, much like Dupree Hart, they're going to solidify that middle of the infield for the Cougars. The 2-0 pitch. There's finally a strike from Cooper Bradford. As we were saying earlier, LSU, their relationship at the time, it was Smoke of All and Matt Heath. Matt Heath also playing up the road at Fernandina Beach High School. Is that one will be another base hit, as make it now 5 base hits over to left field, as there's Luke Manzo. He's got 4 hits this season against UNF and 6 at-bats. And you bring up Dupree Hart. And they're trying to go through the order here for College of Charleston after that 11-2 loss against UNF at their home park. And trying to pay back the Ospreys. So Dupree Hart, 3 runs from Sunday this year, hitting .222 with 6 doubles. Also 18 walks. His team is going to get on base a lot. Those bases on balls. 2 outs and a man on. They'll go over to first and a hard throw. It's Cooper Bradford. I was joking with Diaz. He was walking over to the facility today with Chris Thibodeau. And I said, man, Diaz, you're making some crazy good plays over near the dugout. It made the line of like, yeah, you know, it's taken me this long to finally do that. He's had a couple right along the fencing for the UNF dugout the last 10 days. Waiting for his first pitch is Dupree Hart. Flew out for the 2nd out of the 1st inning. Manzo on first. Here's Bradford and a strike perfectly placed in the zone. So Hart, the count 0-1. You want to check on Manzo of the starters today. He leads them in stolen bases, 4 of 7 this year. So Voyles definitely keeping an eye on Manzo at first. The 0-1 pitch, Hart, that one gets away from the catcher. Oh, and he'll come on back as Manzo will head back to first. That'll be a ball, 1-1. As both these teams have been playing good baseball as of late. The Ospreys, a close game both Friday and Sunday. But winning the last 2 against Kennesaw State, the 1-1, they'll go over to first again. As just 1 arm in the pen, it does look like Adam Polanski out there for the Ospreys, but he has not thrown yet. And he looks the closest, like it might just be a pitching by committee today for UNF. The 1-1 is high to Dupree Hart for 2 balls and 1 strike. As the Ospreys this year, a team ERA of third in the A's Sun. And if you remember last year, these would be games that usually Frank German would start for the Ospreys. A 2-1 pitch to Hart. He'll put that through the hole over to right field. That's going to be a base hit. And Manzo will head to second. So now base hits in six of the last seven at-bats for the Cougars. As it's been all base hit singles except for the grand slam from Ari Sakopoulos. And here's Irvin Roper. So Roper up to bat, and he is going to make it all nine bats in the order. Coming up for College of Charleston with two men on first and second. Two outs in this top of the second. They lead 4-1 to the Cougars over the Ospreys. Bradford gets them with a pinch that just sunk to Roper. As a strike there on the first pitch, and Roper just the lone senior today. But at times, College of Charleston, they do have a little bit of depth, so they can bring in some pitch hitters or somebody to pinch run in the latter three, four innings. Also, this is the first time these two teams have met coming into this year. They did meet back on March 14th, but one of four new opponents for the Ospreys, along with Rutgers, Radford, and Northeastern. The 0-1 from Bradford, and swinging and feeling like he went about 65%, then just followed through for show, I feel like, more than anything. So Irvin Roper, the count, no balls and two strikes. Two men on, Manzo on second with Hart on first. Logan McRae on deck, and definitely don't want to load the bases with the cleanup man McRae getting ready. Bradford, the righty freshman, the 0-2 coming. That one missing outside for a ball. As McRae, his slugging percentage, his RBIs, eight home runs. Rather just hold off until the top of the third. They count 1-2 for Bradford. As a windup here, and Roper will swing and miss. And for a second straight inning, we'll end things off with a Cooper Bradford strikeout. But the Cougars, they do some damage here. Four runs, all coming off a grand slam. They had three straight hits. Richter, Dixon, Wondrak. But a grand slam by Sakopoulos. Then back-to-back singles by Manzo and Hart. We'll take a timeout here. You're listening to UNF Baseball on 1010 XL. Come on back for the bottom of the second. As College of Charleston leads 4-1, it'll be Blake Foyles, Christian Diaz, and Mac Wilson. Bottom of the order after this. On the Ospreys Sports Network. It's the Ospreys Sports Network. Glad to be with you. Midweek baseball. Oh, my goodness. Opening day over the weekend. Monday, I did nothing. Tuesday, did I do anything? I can't even remember. Baseball has just absorbed me the last couple of weeks. So the Ospreys will start off bottom of the order, 7-8-9. Foyles, Diaz, and Wilson with College of Charleston leading 4-1. We're in the bottom of the second. Here's McLarty as Foyles takes the first pitch and a swing. That'll be to right center field and an easy snag there for Luke Morgan. As that's the first fly ball out there for the Ospreys bats today is Christian Diaz, their first baseman. So he had the grand slam in the first meeting. And then it was Ari Sakopoulos who matched that here today. Make sure to keep up on Twitter with the Ospreys, Osprey BSB. So Diaz, a righty bat this year, hitting 255. That one well inside, it looked like. So, inside of the plate. Seems a little generous here today. As Diaz is here against righties, hitting 192. Against lefties, though, he's hitting about 440. Just nuts. There's a ball for 1-1. Christian Diaz this year also 13 runs knocked in, 3 home runs, 5 doubles. As White Sox for both teams, it'll be Blue Tops for the Ospreys. Diaz will pop it up. That'll be to shallow right field as Dupree Hart. You could hear him shouting off and calling off Bradley Dixon, saying, I got it, I got it, I got it. So Diaz will fly out to right. So two quick outs as McLarty has kind of gotten into a little bit more of his groove here for a couple of freshman right-handed pitchers. 4-1 lead for College of Charleston. And Mac Wilson, the second baseman for the Ospreys, outside for a ball. As Mac Wilson, a good day on Saturday, went 1-for-3, a run and a walk. And also a week ago today against Bethune-Cookman, a nice game. Definitely the best of his UNF career. Went 3-for-4 with the runs scored. So McLarty stares in. Leadoff man Pat Irvin on deck for the Ospreys. Still Vaca and Polanski out in the pen. The 1-0 pitch, and that one will be a chopper over the head of the third baseman, Tommy Richter. So he's seen that a couple of times today. Chris Berry in the last inning, and the Ospreys there with Mac Wilson. So Wilson, I want to say that's now hits in, let me do the math real quick. It might take me a few moments, but I want to say it's 4 of his last 6 games, if I'm not mistaken. 2 outs in the bottom of the second. And Pat Irvin for the Ospreys, ground ball out back in the first inning. But really, you could have made an argument if it wasn't for Alex Merritt. I could have seen him being A-Sun Player of the Week. Those two guys were just almost like neck and neck. Ospreys 4 hits today and a run scored. A Thibodeau solo home run. Check over at first. As they'll keep an eye on Mac Wilson. Wilson, that was hit number 9 this year. Pat Irvin knows what that's like. I think we spent like half of Sunday checking on Pat Irvin over at first. Must have been like 25 throws. It's like, ah, oh, man. All right, we check again over Mac Wilson. Irvin, 2 hits, have first go around against College of Charleston. The Ospreys is a big-time run-producing team also, and a big weekend coming up against Nashville and Lipscomb. Tough, tough squad. They return Mike Gigliotti and Lee Solomon. That one over to Dupree Hart. Sliding, he'll just be able to get Pat Irvin, and that's all they need anyway. But the Ospreys get a single off Mac Wilson and another ground ball out by Pat Irvin. As we move to the top of the third with the Ospreys trailing 4-1 against College of Charleston here at Harmon Stadium. You're listening to UNF Baseball on 1010XL. We'll come on back, and it'll be Logan McRae, Tommy Richter, and Bradley Dixon, 4-5-6, here as you're tuned in to the Osprey Sports Network. The Ospreys, and we had a feeling it'd be that way, pitching by committee today for North Florida, as College of Charleston, they have somebody currently warming up. They'll go a lefty as their second pitcher. Until then, it'll be Matt Vaca for the Ospreys. Cooper Bradford giving up four runs in that second frame as the Cougars lead 4-1 over North Florida. It'll be McRae, Richter, and Dixon as we get this inning going. For Matt Vaca, it's been a while since at least I've seen him. I think it's been since the Rutgers game where we called his name on radio. He did throw 52 pitches last week against Bethune-Cookman, going 2 1/3, giving up 5 runs and 5 hits. So he could probably go about 2 innings and some change. I'd expect the Ospreys probably to go 4 or 5 pitchers today. And here's Logan McRae. A leadoff fly ball to start off the second inning. Then it was 4 consecutive hits by the Cougars. Top of the third. And here's Vaca the windup. A starter predominantly his first year as a freshman was stellar. Reminded me a little bit of Austin Drury, those two and their similarities. Then last year was a starter, kind of moved more to the pin roll as it throws a strike on the second pitch. 1-1, Bear to McRae. As Vaca, always fun to be around. Also, one of my favorite team names in minor league baseball is that one will be over to Irvin. It takes one hop high, and Irvin, his second throw this game over to first, and pretty routine over to Christian Diaz to get out Logan McRae. But also in the offseason, and I kind of want to get some gear, is just the Danville Dans. That, to me, is just a fantastic name. It's not quite as legit as Jumbo Shrimp. We bring up Tommy Richter, who started that second with the hit, and that one will go to center field. Thibodeau's going to dive out, and it goes under his glove. That one will roll close to the warning track, and it's going to be Girola, as that one will make it 3 bags and a triple there by Tommy Richter. So Thibodeau giving it everything he had, and Richter, that's going to be his second triple of the year. So with one out, he's in scoring position. And he's already having a fantastic day. 2 hits. That on-base streak is already at 19 games. Hits in 9 of his last 10. And he is in a groove right now for Richter, their third baseman. He's also right now probably going to be hitting a little over 350. The first pitch here catches the outside of the plate. Bradley Dixon takes a strike. He had that second single in the second inning. As Dixon taps home plate outside, then in with his bat. He's a righty. Vaca the quick nod. The 0-1. Low there for a ball. The Osprey outfield. Left field is Wes Weeks. Thibodeau in straightaway center. And over in right field, Yair Girola is one. The first A-Sun player of the week for the Ospreys, then this week it was Alex Merritt. 1-1 pitch from Vaca, and that one to center field. He'll back up, kind of stutter step in center field. Thibodeau, he'll make that fairly routine grab right there. So 2 outs now for the Ospreys, top of the third. And Tommy Richter over on third base, and you bring up the catcher, Danny Wondrak. Wondrak up to bat. 2 hits against the Ospreys this year. As his College of Charleston team, they made the NCAA tournament 3 of the last 4 years. This year picked to be the third best team, but a very good conference. UNC Wilmington has been very good the last few years. Here's the first pitch to Wondrak. Swings and misses. Vaca will win that little battle there. As the Cougars lead 4-1. Or 5-1, excuse me, after they had their man Richter come on home on that sack fly. The 0-1 breaks a little too far outside for Vaca. Now 1-1. And with Wondrak trying to join Tommy Richter with the 2-hit afternoon. So he's still got a little breeze here. The 1-1 pitch coming from Vaca swings and misses. So he's going low in that zone. He's trying to get things to break against Wondrak. 5 Cougars this year have had at least an on-base streak of 11 games. That is really impressive. Only had 7 hits in that first meeting. They have 7 hits right now, and we're in the top of the third. The 1-2 coming and gets some swinging. So the Ospreys give up another run. They trail 5-1 after Richter had the triple that was a nice play by Thibodeau, but just dropped right below his glove. And the Ospreys have three consecutive frames where they've struck out a player to end the inning. We head to the bottom of the third as the Ospreys will send up Chris Thibodeau, Yair Garola, and Alex Merritt. We'll come on back for the bottom of the third in a 5-1 ball game with College of Charleston leading. You're listening to UNF Baseball on 1010XL. Baseball on the Osprey Sports Network. Always a pleasure. Richard Miller with you today, the voice of North Florida Athletics. The Ospreys trail 5-1 against College of Charleston. And it kind of has the feeling of the scripts being flipped a little bit as the Ospreys won 11-2 in that first matchup up in Charleston. Definitely one of my favorite cities. It's one of those places, it's far enough of a drive where you say, I got to make it back here. You know, but it's closed, but it's not, and, you know, it's yeah, there's always an excuse. There's always something on Netflix or some sporting event you can watch, and we'll have, for the Ospreys, Chris Thibodeau, who got the Ospreys on the board early with one out in the bottom of the first with a solo home run as Thibodeau is fifth home run of the year. And it'll be a new pitcher as Will Detweiler, number 36, the lefty, now out. So Griffin McLarty just a little bit of work in those couple of innings. Cooper Bradford, two innings of work, giving up six hits and four runs on 38 pitches. Thibodeau takes a ball there on the first pitch to start off this frame. And McLarty, 27 pitches, so a little quicker work, giving up four hits and a run through two innings. Stetweiler, the lefty, the 1-0, and Thibodeau swings and misses. As UNF, they had three hits in the first inning, one hit in that last frame. As it's been Thibodeau, Merritt, Berry, and Mac Wilson all with hits today. Seven hits on the other side for College of Charleston. A grand slam gave them that big, big lead. And there's another ball from Detweiler, 2-1. Thibodeau, 20 straight games he's reached base safely. You're talking Corbin Olmstead, Donnie DeWeese territory just about. Get a few more games before it's actually like spot on. The 2-1 count, and there's a strike. 2-2 now, so we even things up. For Charleston today, it's been Manzo, Hart, Richter, Dixon, Wondrak, and Sakopoulos all with hits. The two hits, Tommy Richter, two hits and two runs. Two balls and two strikes is Detweiler. Gets set as here's a fifth pitch and fouls it off, and you got a piece of one of those ankles as you kind of hike up the pants and the belt and just kind of almost yell into one of your batting gloves as you tighten it up and maybe blow a snot rocket and act really tough when inside you're going, yell into a pillow. Two balls and two strikes. Bottom of the third is Thibodeau trying to start things off with the hit outside when we get a full count. Here to Chris Thibodeau. The only returning player for the Ospreys to be on that All-A-Sun first team last year. As they'll face Lipscomb this coming weekend and And you get a little bit of a break with NJIT back here at home. The 3-2, Thibodeau, that one up the middle is Detweiler kind of moved back a little bit. Didn't have to. And there's a couple of hits for Chris Thibodeau. So another multi-hit game for Thibodeau. And why would it be anything differently for number 15? I mean, you'd think it would be, but baseball is pretty simple all in all. Is Chris Thibodeau now, it's 11 multi-hit games for the Ospreys center fielder. And here's Alex, or here's Yair Garola for North Florida, struck out on a 3-2 pitch. So the Ospreys are one of two when it goes to a full count. Here's Garola, fouls that one off, and cars are safe on that foul ball. Garola slugging well, and is starting to get into the range of now I'm keeping up with the number of stats, almost like Dallas Moore. Like, what's he going to break now? Who's he going to contend with the single-season records? 11 doubles this year. 2-for-5 in the first game. They go over to first and keep an eye on Chris Thibodeau. Just smart. He leads the team with 8 stolen bases. Behind him, you've got 6 apiece with Garola and Wes Weeks. As Garola's been thrown out twice. Weeks has been thrown out just once. So Detweiler stares on in. So we wait for the 0-1. Here it comes as Garola takes a strike there looking. 0-2 count. As Yair Garola, always just a reliable bat in the lineup against lefties this year, has kind of struggled. Hitting 275. Compared against righties, he's about 375. Alex Merritt on deck for North Florida. The count 0-2 in the bottom of the third. Trailing 5-1. And a little more sidearm there. Ball kind of took some velocity off. Is when really starting to push, you might get some win-aided extra base hits if you'd like some right about now. Nearing almost an hour of game time. As Garola gets ready for the Ospreys. And here's Detweiler. He'll go over to first again. With Smoke Laval stalking the UNF dugout just outside the fencing. Pacing back and forth. Kind of practicing his baseball swing also. Just going with the one hand though. Going with that right hand swinging like a lefty. Here's 1-2. They'll go over to first again for the second straight time. Alex Merritt on deck. A 10-game hit streak. Thibodeau over on first as he's reached base safely in 20 straight. As Merritt getting his first home run of the season over the weekend, he said it was finally nice to kind of get that off his back. He had 7 home runs last year, so he'd kind of gotten used to it. 1-2. Garola. As Detweiler the pitch, and that'll be a ground ball. Chance to turn 2. Shortstop Manzo, the play over at first. And that'll be 2 outs there as Yair Garola hits into the double play, erasing Thibodeau's single and a chance for the Ospreys to cut into this 5-1 lead. We're in the bottom of the third. So here's Alex Merritt. So I'm sure you can hear that Friends theme song every single game. The Ospreys 16-9 at home. Trying to make it 3 straight for the Ospreys. Took Saturday and Sunday. Game was supposed to be yesterday at 4. The rains pushed us back a little bit. And here's Merritt. That one slides in. And nice play by Wondrak, the catcher. Merritt gets himself a ball. Is Chris Berry getting ready for the Ospreys? Merritt had the single in his first at-bat. 9 hits now over the last 8 days. 1-0 pitch. That one's still well inside around that back right cleat. As Merritt will lightly dust those 2 hands with some clay. Get back in the batter's box. 2 balls and no strikes with 2 outs. No men on. Bottom of the third. Third pitch outside. So Alex Merritt, like we joked about over the weekend, he had a chance to hit for the cycle. He had a 3-1 count and just needed a triple. And he said he definitely thought about maybe swinging at that pitch outside. A 3-0. Here's Merritt takes a strike on the inside. Was not going to take a cut on that. It did not look like. Top five batting average in the A's Sun for Alex Merritt, hitting above 350. As the Osprey is trying to make it three straight weeks of a guy on the A's Sun Player of the Week. That one a ground ball hard over to Luke Manzo, the shortstop. The throw as he gives it all he has, and Manzo, a nice play by the sophomore. So the Ospreys get a leadoff single by Chris Thibodeau as Jair Garola hits into a double play. And we head to the top of the fourth here as North Florida trails College of Charleston 5-1. It'll be Matt Vaca back out there for the Ospreys. On the other side of things, we'll go 8-9-1 as it'll be Ari Sikopoulos, Luke Morgan, and Luke Manzo after this for the Cougars. Cougars 5, Ospreys 1. You're listening to 1010XL. It's Ospreys Sports Network, and a pleasure to be with you. As that cloud coverage provides a little bit of relief. And Matt Vaca on the mound, top of the fourth, the 5-1 lead for the Cougars. Low and inside, so Ari Sikopoulos, after a big, big hit, hopefully he gets that baseball. First collegiate home run, and a grand slam in the second. Vaca the 1-0, and Sikopoulos swings and misses. Count moves to 1-1. Defensively for the Ospreys, Voyles another start. He's behind the plate. Infield Diaz at first. Second is Wilson. Shortstop Irvin. Third baseman is Merritt. Vaca the 1-1. Sikopoulos swings on the inside. Big cut. Nothing coming away there. 1-2. As Vaca wastes no time. He's ready as Sikopoulos still has his right foot out of the batter's box. And here it comes on the fourth pitch. And a four-pitch strikeout. So Vaca with back-to-back Ks. And remember also, it's been Vaca and the starter Cooper Bradford combining to strike out and end the inning with three straight Ks. Fourth strikeout of the day for the Ospreys pitchers. It looks like Polanski's going to be the next guy, as he's out in the pen right now. One out, and that one looked maybe a weird hopper. Got some of the padding of catcher Blake Voyles. Luke Morgan, a ground ball for his first at-bat in the second inning. So seven hits the first go-around for the Cougars. They've got seven right now, as there's a strike from Vaca on the outside of the plate. College of Charleston, they won three straight. They're only 3-6 away from home, though. 1-1, here it comes from Vaca the junior. Missing a bit outside. The Ospreys hits today. Thibodeau has two of them. Merritt Berry and Mack Wilson combined for the other three. As two strikeouts for the Cougars' arms today. That one over to right field. Yair Garola will track it down, and he'll make the grab. As that's fairly easy to what he's done in the past, like, say, 2.5 weeks, where he's just made some, like, crazy, you know, like, if I'm your mother, you don't make that play because you could hurt yourself, son. Why would you dive out like that? That's scary. And we go to the leadoff man, Luke Manzo. His third at-bat today, a single back in that very productive second inning for the Cougars. And two outs to start this top of the fourth. So Manzo will take a strike from Vaca. He started to get in a nice little groove as he is now retired four consecutive Cougars. Manzo this year hitting 365 as our leadoff man. There's a ball low. Vaca, I believe it has just been one hat that he has owned since he started his UNF career. The thing just looks rough. And there's Manzo. That one is to the outfield. Weeks, is he going to call for it? Does, and calls off Chris Thibodeau, the center fielder. So the Ospreys get three straight retired. A couple of fly balls to right and to left field. And that is now five straight retired by Matt Vaca. We'll move to the bottom of the fourth as the Cougars lead North Florida 5-1 for the Ospreys. We'll go Chris Barrett, Wes Weeks, and Blake Foyles. 5-6-7 after this. It's UNF Baseball on the Ospreys Sports Network. Ospreys Sports Network, glad to be with you here. We're in the bottom of the fourth with College of Charleston leading 5-1 over North Florida. And for the Ospreys, it'll be Chris Berry, Wes Weeks, Blake Voiles here in this frame. The Ospreys had a leadoff single by Chris Thibodeau. They've had a hit in all three innings, but it's been that four run, that grand slam in the second inning that makes it such a difference right here. 5-1. As a strike there to Chris Berry. A single for him back in the first. As Will Detweiler still on the mound, the 6'1 junior for the Cougars. That one down the right field line. That one is going to be foul. As over at first, Sakopoulos calling that one foul. It goes down to the UNF bullpen. So no balls and two strikes for Chris Berry. Polanski now starting to get a little bit more work. As also Alex Smith and Frank German out there standing. So might see Smitty, I would assume, after maybe Adam Polanski. The 0-2, and that one to second baseman. Takes a little one hop. Dupree Hart to play at first. And Chris Berry retired on the ground ball. So the Ospreys have just gotten two hits over the last seven batters. And you bring up Wes Weeks. He struck out to end the first. And also of note for the Ospreys, it was the first time the pitching staff retired a batter not on a strike, as Luke Manzo flying out to left field. It struck out batters to end the first, second, and tops of the third. First pitch here, and that one will take a chop. Second bounce over to shortstop Luke Manzo, and the play is late over at first. And so that'll be an infield single for Wes Weeks. So Weeks keeps this going for the Ospreys. No matter what, depending on the run production, you're like, yeah, it could be there, could be close or something. But the Ospreys always get hits. They're a top 10 hitting team in the nation. So Detweiler gives up the hit there. And you bring up Blake Voiles. 0-for-1 today is Voiles. As the Ospreys now with six hits. Thibodeau leading the team with two of those and a run scored, of course, with that solo shot. Over to first is Detweiler. On deck is Christian Diaz for the Ospreys. He's also 0-for-1 today. And Saturday has kind of been his day recently for how well number 28 has been swinging the bat. Detweiler stares on in. As Vaca for the Ospreys, 22 pitches through two innings. That one missing the inside There for a ball. 1-0 to Blake Boyles. With Boyles is here hitting .226, 15 runs knocked in, a couple of homers, and four doubles. As Detweiler over 20 pitches. 27 for McLarty in the start today for the Cougars. They go over to first again and check on Wes Weeks. So definitely when it's, say, either Weeks or Thibodeau, you want to keep a watch on first base, and clearly that's a plan between Detweiler and Sakopoulos. The 1-0 pitch as Voiles gets ready. The lefty bat is that one. We'll take one hop. Pretty hard getting the ups there. This ball in South Carolina. And actually the year before, he broke the record of A.J. Green that he had in high school in the state of South Carolina for receiving yards. And he was one of, I think it was four finalists that year for the 2014 Mr. Football for the state of South Carolina, which is just nuts to be that high up there. One way for Diaz, he gets a ball. The Ospreys have Voiles on over at first, but Dupree Hart turning a triple play on Sunday and just an all-around great athlete. One ball, no strikes as Diaz trying to make this a two-run game. That one outside of Christian Diaz, and we get strike one, 1-1 here for Diaz this year with runners on base. Diaz 16 hits and hitting .320 this year. He's trying to get UNF their seventh hit. Had that grand slam the first go-around against College of Charleston. Is Detweiler the 1-1? He'll go over to first instead. Boyles will get some signs from the head coach, Smoke Laval, as he gives a sign and then just kind of throws up his hands. Clearly upset at a few of the ball players now, and maybe the scoreboard most importantly. They count 1-1. Detweiler, the southpaw. Here it comes, and Diaz stays away. Two balls and one strike for Christian Diaz. As he looks over at that dugout, and there's very little shade right now. Maybe just a little bit provided down that third baseline, left field line by the light fixtures. A 2-1, Diaz will swing, and that's over to right field, barely having to move. And right is Bradley Dixon, so that'll do it for the Ospreys. Another hit is Wes Weeks with the single for North Florida. But the Ospreys get the fielder's choice also by Blake Voiles as Weeks was forced out on a nice play by Dupree Hart. So we move to the top of the fifth as College of Charleston leads North Florida 5-1 here at Harmon Stadium. We'll come on back. It'll be 2-3-4 hitters for the Cougars. Dupree Hart, Irvin Roper, and Logan McRae. After this, it's UNF Baseball on the Ospreys Sports Network. Here at Harmon Stadium on what was turned into a hot but still beautiful Wednesday afternoon, top of the fifth, is the Ospreys of North Florida trailing College of Charleston 5-1. Adam Polanski now out on the mound for the Ospreys as the Ospreys have gone with a couple of arms already, starting with Cooper Bradford, two innings of work, giving up four runs and six hits on 38 pitches. Matt Vaca coming in for the next two innings, and he went for the third and the fourth, giving up a run and a hit. And that hit was a triple. Both guys struck out two, so four strikeouts already for the Ospreys. 22 pitches for Vaca as Adam Polanski now out. It'll be Dupree Hart to lead off this fifth inning. Their second bat in the order. He's got a hit today. It'll be Hart, Roper, and McRae. So Hart, the freshman All-American last year. Nice second baseman. He takes a ball to start his at-bat. So they've got seven hits, but five runs already to the Cougars. Grand slam was big back in the second inning. Polanski throws a strike. Now 1-1 account for Hart. As both teams going with their routine, preset pitching order, it looks like. The 1-1 from Polanski outside is Hart showing bunt. Dupree Hart, the sophomore, with 25 hits this year. But definitely just somebody who went on base, always can attempt base stealing. The 2-1 pitch from Polanski, and that one slapped into the UNF dugout. As a few guys were able to get down, it looked like a nice move by Chris Mathias to get out of the way. Also maybe Tyler DuPont. And also maybe Dalton Board. Well, he's probably one of the quickest guys on the team, so that makes sense. So 2-2, here's Polanski. Oh, and outside as Foyles had to stretch for that one. As right now it looks like Hunt in the pen for College of Charleston. Polanski to wind up. Full count here as Hart takes one. High and inside and a walk as the Ospreys had retired five straight. That was all due to Matt Vaca. Polanski starts off with a walk here in the fifth. So Polanski for the Ospreys with a man on. And it's been a while since we've seen Polanski, almost a week, as the 6'4" junior went 2 2/3 against Bethune-Cookman. And maybe his toughest outing of the year, giving up five runs off six hits and threw 47 pitches. As here's Irvin Roper. And they'll go over to first. As a grill definitely going here at Harmon Stadium. You can smell that sizzle here at the ballpark. As Charleston, today they've gotten hits from everybody except Roper, McRae, and Morgan. And there's a ball as Blake Voyle has held that for a little bit. Just trying to make it emphatic and try and get that strike for his pitcher. Roper today 0 for 2, a couple of strikeouts in the first and the second innings. And here's the 1-0 as the runner stays. And there's a high and outside corner. Roper delivered another strike, 1-1 the count. As it's been the surprise bats of the 5, 6, 7, 8 hitters today for the Cougars, leading 5-1 in the top of the fifth. And Polanski, the 1-1 pitch, that'll be a ground ball. Mac Wilson, he'll get a little spin. The throw for the force out at second. And much like Dupree Hart had in the last frame, a nice play there by the second baseman. As it was a little low to Irvin, but Irvin able to make that grab there. So Roper able to get to first, but Hart will head back to the dugout and one out. And this top of the fifth, and the cleanup man, Logan McRae. As McRae, just a redshirt freshman, for some reason, reading his stats and his bio, I assumed maybe he was like a junior, but man, he's a good young player with a couple more years left. He gets a strike from Polanski. And also, you know, you look at this lineup, and you know, definitely the Cougars can vie this year. I think their best opportunities might be for 2018, 2019 of making a good push, not to the NCAA tournament, but through it. That one to center field, that'll drop about 6 feet in front of Chris Thibodeau for base hit from Logan McRae, and he's now 1-for-3 today. So McRae doesn't want to be the last Cougar to get a base hit this afternoon, as it's now just Roper and Morgan are the last two Cougars without a hit. And Tommy Richter, who's had the best day so far, I guess maybe Sakopoulos can make an argument with his grand slam, but a single and a triple today for Tommy Richter. As, well, maybe try and send it out to Thibodeau again. One out and two on now, and that'll be over to right field. And Garol will take that one and heading around third, and that'll be another run for College of Charleston. As that'll be an RBI single, and Roper comes on in. Off another, that's now a three-hit afternoon for Tommy Richter. And he is definitely clicking as he was the one to get things going, and the party started in the second inning for the Cougars before they had the grand slam. So one out top of the fifth with two men on first and second. McRae and Richter both with singles. Brad Dixon has got a single. It was back in the second. So here's Dixon. That one pops in front of Blake Foyles, and the runners will advance there with a ball from Adam Polanski. And a wild pitch for Adam Polanski. And he's having a tough go about right here as Alex Smith is the arm warming up for the Ospreys. So we'll see him for the sixth and the seventh. And maybe you finish it with, say, Eddie Miller or Tyler DuPont. Whoa, Polanski delivers that one outside again. And, man, Foyles is going to be sore on that, you know, that left shoulder kind of trap area. He keeps having to reach for that one. Polanski, his first wild pitch since the game against Penn. That was back on March 5th. They count 2-0 with the bases, second and third. And there's a ball. Once again, so the count 3-0 against number 3, Bradley Dixon, is 1-for-2 today. And he can produce as Dixon this year trying to get maybe his 19th and 20th RBI. Is the 3-0 is low, so 4-pitch walk. And in Major League Baseball, you just signal that I want to walk them intentionally. But that was not done on purpose, so it's been every batter this inning has reached base. A walk, Roper on a fielder's choice, McRae on a single by Richter with an RBI. And now a walk to Dixon, and the base is loaded for the second time today. And Danny Wondrak up to bat. 1-for-2, a single in the second. Low and well inside for a ball. So Dixon, much like Richter, and also Dupree Hart, have been on base twice today. So Wondrak with a big opportunity, 3 home runs this year. That one again, a good bit outside as Voiles kind of comes out, maybe a foot and some change past the batter's box to toss it to Polanski. And the count 2-0 as Wondrak looks at the home plate umpire, 2 balls. No strikes with the bases loaded, top of the fifth, and it's a 6-1 lead for the Cougars. Polanski to wind up, and that one is up, that one over to left field, but a run should come across, is tagging over at third, and the Cougars will make it 7-1 there on the sack fly by Wondrak. So he'll get a little dap right there as Wondrak meets his teammate, Logan McRae. And McRae comes around for his first run of the day. So a 2-run frame here in the top of the fifth with runners first and second. And you bring up Sakopoulos for the third at bat this afternoon. Grand slam and a strikeout today. The Ospreys trailing 7-1. Polanski, the first pitch, it swings and misses, and it's a strike. It looked like maybe it caught maybe a finger. It looks like we're going, I think, Rawlings batting gloves and maroon and white for Sakopoulos. With the count 0-1 and two men on. So 5 of the 6 bats have been on base today. The 0-1 pitch, and that one a ground ball as it takes a couple of hops and then a roll to Christian Diaz at first. And he'll take that himself right there. So seven bats in total come up for the Cougars as they get a two-run frame here in the top of the fifth, as they're able to get a couple walks and a couple of hits. An RBI single by Richter got things going. A sack fly by Danny Wondrak. We head to the bottom of the fifth as the Ospreys trail College of Charleston 7-1. It'll be Mac Wilson, Pat Irvin, and Chris Thibodeau right after this from Harmon Stadium. It's UNF Baseball on 1010XL. Doing that baseball on 1010XL. Mac Wilson will start things off. It's the bottom of the fifth here from Harmon Stadium. We'll go Wilson and then top of the order with Pat Irvin and Chris Thibodeau, as Will Detweiler back out there for College of Charleston. They have a 7-1 lead on this midweek game, trying to split the season series. And a strike there from Detweiler, who worked two innings so far, just giving up a couple of hits. And that 27th pitch ties the starter, Griffin McLarty. Four ground balls to one fly ball for Detweiler. A single for Wilson back in the second. Takes another strike. There is. That's a nice pitch from Detweiler. 0-2. UNF is either first or second in eight different offensive categories. And they count no balls and two strikes for Mac Wilson. That one well outside. Wilson not going to chase that, as he has started now five games in a row at second base. As Chris Berry has either had a day of rest or gone to the DH spot. So I think Berry might be the kind of permanent designated hitter for the majority of the A-Sun schedule. The 1-2, Wilson will swing and went far enough, and he'll strike out on four pitches. And Detweiler, a nice at-bat for number 36, as Wilson there strikes out for just the seventh time this year. And here's Pat Irvin, but it looks like it'll be a pitching change. And so Irvin will see a third pitcher today, or the third pitcher. First two innings, he saw the same guy in Griffin McLarty, and we'll take a quick timeout here as a pitching change for College of Charleston. Cougars lead 7-1 as we'll come on back here. Harmon Stadium, it's UNF Baseball on 1010XL. Pitching change for College of Charleston as they've got a pretty significant lead here, 7-1. We're in the bottom of the fifth on a sunny day from Harmon Stadium in Jacksonville, Florida. So Pat Irvin will face the third pitcher here. And, you know, for a little bit I was wondering if Detweiler was going to go much farther, as he's been the longest outing of the day for all five pitchers now. But Detweiler 2 1/3, as he gave up two hits on 30 pitches and getting four ground balls. Check out the Ospreys on Twitter, OspreyBSB, as Pat Irvin here for the Ospreys. The leadoff man, 0-for-2, a couple of ground balls for Irvin. As Irvin this year against righties, and you can kind of understand why the change was made, but Irvin does very well against right-handed pitchers. 0-for-2 today, but above 350 on the year. And with one out and the ball to Irvin. So Clay Hunt, the new pitcher, as he comes out of the pen, and Hunt also had an outing against the Ospreys the first go-around back in the 14th of March. Went an inning and a third, gave up two runs and a hit, also a walk, as Irvin, that one popped up over to right field. Should be fairly easy. Shades on for Bradley Dixon, and a fly ball to right for Patrick Irvin. And center fielder Chris Thibodeau up for the Ospreys. Couple hits today. Home run in the first inning, a single in the third inning for the Ospreys. And Clay Hunt trying to get his second out and send us to the top of the sixth. I kind of like that name, Clay Hunt. Kind of good. My wife's maiden name is Hunt. We've thought about that maybe as a middle name. I don't know. It's just tough naming a child. It's hard work. First pitch, and Thibodeau, a ball high. Because some first names don't go with middle names. Then you got to worry about the initials lining up and being something weird. Just, it's too much brain power. Here's Hunt, the 1-0 pitch, and Thibodeau won't swing. A strike. They're 1-1. Rahana, sophomore, again, a lot of more youngsters on this team for Matt Heath in his second year at College of Charleston. Cougars a 7-1 lead, one ball, one strike for Thibodeau. With two outs, he'll swing, and that one will be into center field for a base hit, as that'll drop in front of Luke Morgan. So a three-hit afternoon for Chris Thibodeau, a couple of singles and a home run. And Thibodeau has definitely found his groove today. He had three hits all weekend against Kennesaw State. And so he is playing some of the best ball of his senior season. As Thibodeau, just the fourth time he's had three hits in a game this year. And did have one afternoon where he had four hits in a game. He has a chance to do that again today. So two outs and a man on first, and Yair Garola takes a ball outside. A strikeout and hit into a double play earlier. For Garola, 30 runs knocked in, six home runs, and two hits the first time up in Charleston. Hunt is there. Is the ball. Alex Merritt on deck for the Ospreys. Most likely, I would assume, it'll be Alex Smith, the next pitcher for the Ospreys. Two balls, no strikes. Thibodeau on at first. Does he think about trying to steal a base? Maybe if there's a strike here or the next pitch. Garola takes a strike there. Kind of move that right shoulder back a little bit. Last outing most recently, Hunt coming out. It was almost exactly a week ago against Georgia Southern. Gave up a run, which was unearned. Three hits over just one inning. The 2-1, here's Garola. He'll swing, and that one chopped high. Moving in is Dupree Hart. He'll make the routine play over at first. And Dupree Hart is just a vacuum, as nothing is going to get by that freshman All-American. We head to the top of the sixth as the Ospreys trail College of Charleston 7-1 here at Harmon Stadium. It'll be 9-1-2. Luke Morgan, Luke Manzo, and Dupree Hart up to bat after this. You're listening to UNF Baseball on the Ospreys Sports Network. Adam Polanski out there for the Ospreys, so maybe he gives UNF an out or two, maybe the full inning, and then you go to Alex Smith as we start with the bottom of the order here is Luke Morgan for College of Charleston. The Cougars, a 7-1 lead over the Ospreys, top of the sixth at Harmon Stadium. As Polanski so far, 23 pitches, an inning of work, giving up two runs, two hits, and walking two. Here's his eighth batter faces. That's a comebacker. And right around the shins, that'll be into center field for base hit. So Luke Morgan, this almost feels exactly like the first game. Just flip the names on the scoreboard. A 7-1 lead. The Ospreys took the first meeting almost 3 weeks ago, 11-2. In that game, every Osprey had a hit. Now it's just Irvin Roper without a hit today, as the Cougars have sent up seven bats twice in the five frames already here at Harmon Stadium. Leadoff man Luke Manzo will take a strike. So Morgan now 1-for-3 with that base hit. Morgan now 10 hits on the year. And also impressive because Sakopoulos, that grand slam in the second inning, that was his only fifth collegiate hit. That's it. He's a freshman. 6'4 and 220. Polanski count one ball and one strike to Luke Manzo. A single for him. That was back in the second inning where the Ospreys were able to get out of that. That was Cooper Bradford at the time with two men on first and second. 1-1, that one passed to the right of Patrick Irvin, his right, into left field, and another base hit. So a two-hit afternoon for Luke Manzo, and back-to-back hits again for College of Charleston. As Mukhaval will come on out and talk to Adam Polanski, and he immediately points to the bullpen. So that'll do it for Adam Polanski, giving up two straight hits to start this sixth inning, and the Cougars lead the Ospreys 7-1. We'll take a break and come on back with this pitching change for Alex Smith as you're listening to UNF Baseball on 1010XL. Alex Smith comes out for the Ospreys, so Polanski, his afternoon is over. And this midweek tilt where the Ospreys trail College of Charleston 7-1. It's the top of the sixth as the Ospreys already this afternoon. They've used Cooper Bradford to start. He went two innings of work. Matt Vaca went two innings. Adam Polanski went one inning and gave up two hits to start this frame in the sixth. So Polanski, 27 pitches. For Vaca, he went 22. Bradford went 38. You go to Alex Smith, who for the Ospreys this year, 8 of his 10 appearances, North Florida has ended up with a victory. So that does give you some hope right there. His 11th appearance today, an ERA of 4.40. And you remember last year, because Alex Smith was virtually untouchable as a pitcher. He would come in 7th or 8th inning, had a great outing last season down in Gainesville, also against the Gators, but Alex Smith is ERA of 1.11. That is top five all-time in program history. Here's Alex Smith, 14 and a third of work so far. Teams are hitting 305 against him. And Dupree Hart with his fourth at-bat, a single and a walk in his last two plate appearances. He's got two men on first and second with no outs. And here's Smitty, low and almost in the dirt just about. Voiles keeps it from being fully dusty. As Smitty stares in, they count one ball and no strikes. Right-handed redshirt senior, second pitch, and Hart takes a strike. As the Ospreys, it looks like Austin Howes now out in the pen. So maybe Howes will finish off the game with a couple of innings plus of work. And here's Alex Smith on the 1-1. Dupree Hart takes ball two low and around those shoelaces. 11 hits today for the Cougars. They had 7 hits in that first matchup. Make sure you find us on Twitter, Osprey BSB, as Smitty here, righty versus righty for Hart. 3 runs on Sunday, trying to get another run today. The 2-1, and that one popped up. It'll leave the infield just barely. Second baseman Mac Wilson in shallow right field. And with one out, we move to the DH, Irvin Roper. And Roper is just the lone man remaining for the Cougars starter without a base hit. Struck out in his first 2 at-bats is Roper today, 0-for-3. Does have a run scored, though, as he reached on that fielder's choice. And then also came on in after that RBI single in the last inning from Tommy Richter. So top of the 6th with 1 out, 2 men on for College of Charleston. First and second. Smith, here the pitch to Roper, and there's a strike from one of his teammates. They call him Smitty. Clay Hunt going 2/3 of an inning in that last inning. Just gave up a hit and only 9 pitches. 1 fly ball and 1 ground ball for Hunt. The 0-1 pitch, and that one is popped up. It'll be out of play behind us as Voiles was ready to make a grab, as that'll hit the bleacher seats. Everybody's safe, though. No youngsters. You know, you got to be in school. We got truancy laws around here. So you can't go chase that down, and unless you're a student here, you can chase it down. So here's Roper trying to get on base for the second time today. The count 0-2. And Smitty, it comes in well high. Voyle is able to snag that from being a ball that gets well behind him. He stretches that left leg. And I'm telling you, after a few of those pitches from Cooper Bradford and also I think it was Polanski had a couple. And Avaku is good for the most part. But there were a few that, you know, maybe a little extra yoga tomorrow morning for Blake Voyles. 1 ball and 2 strikes. And here's Roper. He's not going to swing. Back-to-back balls now from the Ospreys, Smith. Smith, 4 straight games where he's appeared, and the Ospreys have gotten a victory. That almost sounds like he's kind of like a genie or something. Just appeared, and the Ospreys win. A 2-2 pitch from Smith, and that one high, almost swinging was Roper. And we get a full count here in the 6th inning. 2 hits to open things up by the Cougars in this frame, and they are both against Polanski. Ospreay is able to get a fly ball from Hart over to Mac Wilson. The 3-2 coming. Roper pops it up. It'll be out of play over a dugout by the Cougars. Into the tree. It trickles on down. As I still got to make time for that new IFC show, Brockmire. Looks really good. Hank Azaria, man of many voices. See, that's what happens. When you get bored as a child, you find some way to entertain yourself. You become talented like Robin Williams, Hank Azaria. Just find these gifts that you never knew you had. Full count is Smith against Roper and fouls it off again. And we'll keep things going. Ospreay infield, Diaz at first, second base, Mac Wilson, shortstop, Patrick Irvin. With the third baseman, Alex Merritt. Blake Voiles behind the plate. Right field is Yair Garola. Straightaway center, Chris Thibodeau. Over to left field is Wes Weeks. With the Cougars leading 7-1, it's the top of the 6th. Full count, runners first and second. Smith the pitch, and that one over to left field. It'll be gloved by Wes Weeks moving in, and an easy fly ball, but A good at-bat there by Irvin Roper. And Logan McRae, the cleanup man, single in his last at-bat as he's 1-for-3 today. And McRae on the year, 23 runs and 35 hits. So just one above his number, as he is one of the really good players. I think he's probably going to be, if not first team, definitely a second team All-CAA if he keeps this up. Two outs and two men on for him, first and second. Here's Smee low and away. And a ball there from Alex Smith. Tommy Richter on deck, and you know, we kind of joked about it. I believe it was in that second inning when it was a grand slam to make it 4-1. You wanted to stay away from McRae, but now you want to stay away from Richter. He has three hits this afternoon, and McRae over to right field. Garola is going to reach for it, and that one's going to hit his glove and bounce into the outfield behind him. So on a 1-0 pitch, McRae sends that to right field, and that's going to bring some runs across, and that'll be two runs right there coming across for the Cougars, and an error for Yair Garola, and make it 9-1 now for College of Charleston. So Logan McRae reaches on an error. He's over at third base and starting to feel much like the fifth inning and the second inning, and here's Tommy Richter. So Garola, not a super difficult ball to play, just right below that waistline. As that's a comebacker off the right ankle of Alex Smith. That's going to score a run. And that's a base hit as Alex Smith seems to be okay. You know, probably got him more around the boot portion of the cleat. And seems fine. No issue there. So that'll be another hit. And Tommy Richter, my goodness, a four-hit afternoon. So he has had four of their 12 hits, three for singles and a triple that fell under the glove of Chris Thibodeau. And now Bradley Dixon, a walk and a single today. He's got a man on first. And the ball right there. So the Ospreys, Alex Smith coming in for Adam Polanski. Those first two hits, those runs will be chalked up to Polanski as Austin Howes getting some warm-up throws in. A strike there to make it 1-1 against Bradley Dixon. Been on base safely in 18 in a row. Just very, very reliable over these last almost three weeks, I believe. One ball and one strike. Now, Smith, the pitch. Missing outside 2-1. With Richter heading back to first. So Richter, just a great afternoon. 19 straight as one of his better games this year. Now today, the 2-1 coming in, and there's a strike. We even it up at 2-2. As North Florida starting the game off with Cooper Bradford, two innings. Matt Vaca going two innings. Just an inning and a couple of batters pitching in to the sixth as he went an inning, giving up four runs, two earned off four hits, did walk two. That one fouled off and will stay alive for 2-2 against Bradley Dixon. And Alex Smith just trying to finish off this inning as he's given up a run and a hit. That error also affecting him as he's right there almost to 20 pitches. As it's almost exactly like the first game where UNF won 11-2. The 2-2 pitch missing outside and a full count for the second time in this frame. And Dixon either trying to be walked for the second time, get a hit for the second time today, but we'd like him to be retired for the second time. The 3-2 from Smith, and that one will be chopped. Glove by Mac Wilson. It comes out of the netting. A tough ball there on the second hop, and that's going to be a hit there for Bradley Dixon. So he's got a two-hit afternoon. As it's now 13 hits for College of Charleston. They've just been clicking, and clearly one of the reasons, if they're not the best team right now? I mean, they're 5-1 in the CAA. UNCW, at least from what I saw last year, you felt like they were going to be very good or great for a number of years, but especially with Nick Fite on the team. Danny Wondrak up to bat now for the Cougars with two outs and two men on. That one gets away from Blake Voiles. And almost getting a piece of Wondrak. And it's going to be a pass ball on Blake Voiles as the runners head to second and third now for College of Charleston. As today it has been three guys with two or more hits for the Cougars. Two hits for Manzo, four for Richter, and two for Dixon. And Danny Wondrak waiting for the 1-0 from Smith. And he fouls that one off. It'll get the tarp over near the Osprey Nest. Almost like, you know, as Christian Diaz stayed away from that tarp, it was almost like last night during the Stetson UF game where the Florida coaches decided to just completely stay away from the tarp. So, like, we'll stay dry in the dugout is what we'll do. One ball and one strike. Two outs and two men on for Smith. Here's the third pitch, and that one over the head of the second baseman, Mac Wilson, into right field. That's going to be a two-run single, a play at the plate. No, just a little late on the throw. And so Wondrak with a two-hit afternoon, and he'll get a couple more ribbies for his name for the starting catcher. And it's now 12-1, and you bring up full circle, it's Ari Sakopoulos, the man that has made this first a 4-1 lead, but it's been now 12 unanswered runs by College of Charleston. Sakopoulos, a grand slam in that second inning, and he takes a strike. So it's still two outs, a man on first after a two-run single by Danny Wondrak. And for Wondrak this year, 20 runs knocked in as he's getting close to Logan McRae. And here's Alex Smith, then that one off speed. And another strike, 0-2. Cougars lead 12-1 over the Ospreys as UNF has mustered seven hits, but it's been scattering of hits. 15 with 12 runs for College of Charleston. The 0-2, that one well inside. As some of UNF's pitchers have had consistency, I'd say Matt Vacco is definitely the most consistent. He gave up just a run and one hit. Everybody else has given up at least three runs and three hits. The 1-2 and swings and misses. And there is, after nine at-bats, another inning where the Ospreys end it with the strikeout, much like the first, second, and third innings. So four of the six today, the Ospreys have moved to the home half with the K. And we head to the bottom of the sixth. Charleston leads 12-1 over North Florida, as the Ospreys will send up 4, 5, 6 hitters. Alex Merritt, Chris Berry, and Wes Weeks. After this, it's UNF Baseball on 1010XL. So same pitcher for College of Charleston as the Cougars have a big lead. A five-run frame in that top of the six as they plated two runs in the fifth and also four runs in the second. And the Ospreys will go Alex Merritt, Chris Berry, and Wes Weeks in the bottom of the sixth. Clay Hunt, the pitcher for the Cougars, as he sees his second inning and fouled off, it'll go off the wall and back into the field of play for strike one to Merritt. Hunt in that last inning, just a couple of outs for two-thirds of work, gave up one hit, as he's only thrown 10 pitches, so he's got plenty left in him. As Barry has continued his stretch, he's got 19 straight where he's been on base safely. The 0-1, and Merritt falls behind 0-2 with the strike there. As Alex Merritt this year, another solid season, as he's hitting almost 400 against righties. So definitely the matchup you want. The 0-2, and that one, well hit. That one over to left field, tracking it down. Logan McRae, just a couple feet from the warning track, and out number one. As Alex Merritt will head back to the dugout. So that's three straight retired, as Clay Hunt was the second arm out of the pen for College of Charleston. And Chris Berry up for the Ospreys. 1-for-2 today. As still, I mean, second best on-base percentage in the A-Sun is just stellar. As a DH here over the last week, pitched outside for a ball. As Chris Berry recently hitting .318, slugging .435 on base at a .458 clip. And also pretty good fielder. The 1-0 is Barry takes a strike high in the zone. Wes Weeks on deck. No, actually, it's going to be Dalton Board who's on deck currently. So he's going to come in to pinch hit in a little bit for Wes Weeks. And Barry with one ball and one strike. With one out, and Barry stays away, gets a strike called on him. Close there on that high outside corner. Outfield for the Cougars, and right is Dixon. Straightaway center is Morgan. Left field is Logan McRae with that first out on a nice little grab there. The Ospreys with their one run coming in the first. Barry will pop that one up. It'll be over to left field. Calling for it again is McRae. And two men down now, and you bring in the pinch hitter, Dalton Board. So Board in for the Ospreys. As Dalton Board this year for UNF, a sophomore, his 15th appearance and 21st at-bat, as he's got a couple of runs knocked in, four hits and five runs scored. So Dalton Board comes up to bat. A sophomore from Bishop Kenny in the lefty bat, also a speedster. So if you need that late inning pinch runner, he's definitely going to be that guy. As Clay Hunt now an inning and a third of work, two outs in the bottom of the sixth, a 12-1 lead for Charleston. Here's Hunt outside, Board will take ball one. Foyle's on deck now, so it looks like the Ospreys will just go one pinch hitter in this game. As Board, here's a 1-0, and Hunt inside, too far, 2-0. Dalton Board opens up. So Roper is still the lone player for Charleston without a hit. And the Ospreys on the other side of things. Chris Thibodeau is 3-for-3 with a run. And that home run, the 2-0, as Board takes a fastball high, a big cut to make it 2-1. Dalton Board hitting 200 this year with those four hits and 20 at-bats. Mainly more of a pinch hitter, but does have four starts this year. The 2-1, as he'll pop that out, it'll slice foul over the Charleston dugout. The Ospreys today, seven hits though, but it only took through just not even a full three for seven hits from Charleston after they had seven hits in the first matchup with the Ospreys. The 2-2, here's Dalton Board. He takes a ball in his first at-bat. We'll get a full count with two outs after both Merritt and Barry were retired. Today's starting lineup, the same from Saturday against Kennesaw State, so something you might see against Lipscomb also. Dalton Board fouls at foul wide of that first baseline. As Dalton Borb will settle back in and get another full out pitch. Austin Howe is still getting some longer toss out in the pen. Also, seems to be kind of like Tyler DuPont using a little bit more sidearm now. The full count, Dalton Borb pops that up. It'll be the center field backing up a little bit, Luke Morgan. And the Ospreys retired 1-2-3, as that is now five straight retired by the reliever Clay Hunt. And we head to the top of the seventh as the Cougars lead 12-1. And they'll send up Luke Morgan, Luke Manzo, and Dupree Hart after this. You're listening to UNF Baseball on the Osprey Sports Network. The Osprey Sports Network, a beautiful day as that wind picks up a little bit more. Unfortunately, the Ospreys trailing 12-1 and we're in the top of the seventh. New pitcher for the Ospreys is Austin Howes now out there for UNF. But hey, College of Charleston, man, their bats have gotten warm. 12 runs, 15 hits. The Ospreys with their first error since last week. They did not have an error all weekend against Kennesaw State. So here's Austin Howes for the Ospreys, and it'll be Luke Morgan, much like that last inning. It's been now two innings, the second and the sixth, where they've sent up nine bats in a frame. As the Cougars start off, and a foul ball behind the backstop by Morgan. As this year for Austin Howes, this will be appearance number 12, ERA of 4.19. And struck out 17, teams hitting 321 against him. The 0-1 to Morgan. As he breaks that one back in across the plate. We last saw Howes. He's been out in the pen a couple of games. I believe it was the middle game on Saturday against Kennesaw State, but made an appearance against Dallas Baptist for 2 1/3. As that one breaks away and they don't get a call down along first and late, but did not go, is Luke Morgan. Had a single to lead off the sixth, as he's 1-for-3 with the count 1-2. And here's Howes with the pitch, and that one over to right field. Backing up, Garola's going to have to chase that one down, and that one goes off the wall. So it's going to be a couple of bases there, and an extra base hit is Luke Morgan, who, along with Roper, not have base hit, but Morgan with a leadoff double. So a double there by Morgan, and that's his second two-bagger of the year. He'll get a little time called to take off the two batting gloves. And leadoff man with Manzo, two hits today, singles in the second and the sixth. And he has been pretty key in those two big frames, which combined for nine of the team's 12 runs. And there's a strike to start off from Howes. As Howes, four of his last five appearances, he's going to go about an inning and a third. Sometimes just two quick outs if smoke needs them. And the 0-1 from Howes. That one well low. A 1-1 strike. As we reach 2 hours of game time here at the ballpark for Harmon Stadium, where the Ospreys, it'll be the first time they've gone on the road for more than just one game. He'll head out for Nashville on Thursday. The 1-1 pitch, and Manzo, another ball. Now 2-1. as they've got Ryder currently out in the pen for College of Charleston. And Tyler DuPont now in for UNF out in the pen as there's a strike. Now 2-2 with Howes on the mound and Luke Manzo. He's got a man in scoring position. Manzo is here coming in. On base percentage of .468. So gets on base just about as much as Chris Berry does. And the 2-2 pitch. Manzo will swing that one over to first. Blocked well right around the belt. And Christian Diaz with a great play, as he probably had about three or four of those over the weekend. And the runner heads over to third after that leadoff double by Morgan. So Manzo, third time he's been retired today. And here's the second baseman, Dupree Hart. So Hart a single and a walk this afternoon. As Howes a nod, and here's the first pitch, and a comebacker off the glove of Howes. Shortstop Patrick Irvin, the play. Oh, and he got him indeed. As a pump there by the first base umpire, Jeff Gosney. But a run scores nevertheless is Luke Morgan. But a nice play as Howes and comboed there with Patrick Irvin, keeping an eye on it. It's now 13-1 with the Cougars leading the Ospreys and a strike to Irvin Roper. So Roper, the lone man here. He's been on base once. Struck out his first two at-bats against Cooper Bradford. And with two outs, went the top of the seventh. The Ospreys have given up 13 unanswered runs. Low and well inside, 1-1. So you get the feeling maybe split a little bit of work and give DuPont maybe the last inning and some change as that one gets fouled off. Now 1-2. Irvin Roper. Keep up with the Ospreys throughout the year as conference play picks back up on Friday up in Nashville. On Twitter, Osprey BSB. The website, UNFOspreys.com. The 1-2 from Howes. That one again, having to make Voiles work behind the plate to stay in front of that. Able to make it roll in front of him a little bit now as we even things up 2-2. So again, like that first matchup, an 11-2 UNF win. The 2-2 pitch, and that one comes back, and it knocks a glove off of Howes' hand. And that'll be a base hit there by Irvin Roper. And it's now every starter for the Cougars with base hit, and a fascinating way to make it happen right there. It had to be glamour-filled, to say the least. And we've got multi-hit games now for 1, 2, 3, 4. It is 5 of the 9 starters for Charleston. A 13-1 lead, 17 hits today, 2 outs and a man on. And here's Logan McRae. Takes a pitch high for a ball. McRae, a single, also reaching on an error. As North Florida with that one error over in right field by Garola, the 1-0 pitch with 2 outs, and that one pulled. It'll be foul, and that's going to be probably, I think, where Ultimate Frisbee sometimes has some afternoon games. Remember, you can catch it, then you can pivot. You can pivot. You can slow down, so I think it's 3 or 4 steps in ultimate. The 1-1, here it comes from Howes. McRae, that one to the shortstop, gloved easily, and dump off by Patrick Irvin to get the fours out as Wilson will get Irvin Roper. And we'll take a stretch here ahead to the bottom of the seventh as College of Charleston leads 13-1. All their starters with the base hit, 17 hits on the day. And we'll go for the 7-8-9 hitters for the Ospreys. Blake Foyles, Christian Diaz, and Mac Wilson. Right after this, it's UNF Baseball on 1010 XL. It's the Osprey Sports Network with a little bit of a stretch. We're in the bottom of the seventh, and the Ospreys lead 13-1. College of Charleston leads 13-1. New pitcher is Trent Ryder, the righty. The freshman, 6'5" and about 230. Now towing the rubber. The Ospreys, it looks like no changes. Actually, it looks like maybe Joe Boyle will be batting in this inning, as Boyle may be going to replace Mac Wilson. So it'll be Blake Foyles to start us off as his third at-bat of the day. And 13-1, the Ospreys only able to get seven hits today. And that one run, it was a solo home run. What about 4-10 off the bat of Chris Thibodeau? And here's Ryder, throws a ball. As this young man, his father playing baseball at Elon. The 1-0, quick nod here from Ryder. Second pitch and Foyles got a piece of it somehow, and it'll be a throw down to first, and a nice play by Danny Wondrak, the catcher, as it just took a weird hop there. I think Foyles was the only one that was for sure that it was it went off his bat. Otherwise, it looked kind of strange there. Last outing for Ryder was against North Florida, as he has not entered a game that his team has won since almost 2 months ago when they played at Georgia and took 2 of 3 from the Bulldogs. So one out, and here's Christian Diaz, as it's now been 6 straight Ospreys retired. Diaz takes one, almost getting that left tricep. On deck for the Ospreys is Joe Boyle. As Boyle will come in to pinch hit for Mac Wilson. One out, bottom of the seventh. The Ospreys trying to get their second run of the game. And 1-0 coming from Ryder. And that one up. It'll be in foul territory, most likely. And it'll drop in the left fielder. Can't make a grab on it. Logan McRae, as he was playing closer more to that Dusty Rhodes field sign. And not quite the speed over there to get to it. Took a hop and was able to glove it. It took that hop in foul territory. So Diaz, 1-1. Had a stellar game and a grand slam the first time. That was on the road about 4 hours north. Diaz today is 17th start over at first base. He's spent time between that and DH. Here comes a 1-1. Ryder, that one gets away from the glove of Wondrak for 2. It's Christian Diaz. This year for the Ospreys is kind of solidified first in a lot of their games. Started 27 in total. So 10 spent at DH as we get a straight ball over from the UNF bullpen. The 2-1 and Diaz, that'll pop up over to right field. Brad Dixon will glove that. Had to use that glove to shield his eyes a little bit. Does have the Oakleys on, but sometimes that sun just beats through the glasses. It doesn't matter if they're UVA and UVB protected. Just need a little bit more help there. And here comes Joe Boyle in for the Ospreys, number 10. As Joe Boyle comes in for Mac Wilson. So Wilson will end his day 1-for-2, as he's played very good lately. And Joe Boyle trying to get back into a rhythm. His last hit was against Bradley on the 18th of March, as he'll face a Ryder. So the Ospreys are second pitch hitter, and a ball inside to Boyle. As Boyle will occasionally come in to pinch hit, and from time to time, get some starts over at third base. 1-0. Here for Ryder, the windup. 6'5", and Boyle is swinging a miss. It looked like maybe a change up there. 2 outs and nobody on for Joe Boyle. Tyler DuPont out of the bullpen for the Ospreys. Bottom of the seventh with UNF trailing 13-1. The 1-1 pitch. As Boyle went 0-for-2 last Wednesday, that one sent up sky high. Left fielder McRae moves on in, and it'll be three up been three down, and that is now seven consecutive batters retired by the Cougars bullpen. And we head to the top of the eighth, and it'll be the middle of the order. We'll go 5, 6, and 7 after this for College of Charleston as the Cougars lead 13-1 with the eighth inning coming up here. Harmon Stadium, it's UNF Baseball on the Ospreys Sports Network.
Don't drop the ball.
It's the Osprey Sports Network. We start off the eighth inning, and Eddie Miller, another pitcher for the Ospreys, as UNF trails College of Charleston 13-1. As the Ospreys got that first victory against College of Charleston 11-2, it looks like the Cougars well on their way to taking this one here, as every starter has gotten a hit, and they have five of those nine have two or more hits today. So Eddie Miller now out for the Ospreys on the mound, as today UNF has gone with a multitude. First game they went five, as today they've gone with their sixth pitcher. They started with Bradford. He went two innings. Faka went two innings. Then an inning apiece for Polanski, Smith, and Howes. And so Miller will get things going. And the Ospreys' bats have definitely cooled off also lately in a strike from Eddie Miller. So Miller against Richter, who's been really, really good today. Four hits, and Miller, the 0-1 pitch. That one breaks away as Miller, he got a little piece of that one to make it 0-2. As it's been two of the last three innings for the lineup for the Cougars, they've sent up at least seven bats the last inning. Only sent up six. The 0-2, here's Miller, and that gets him looking on a questionable strike there, but nevertheless, a three-pitch K to send Richter to the dugout for the first time. So Bradley Dixon now up to bat. Couple of singles and a walk today for Dixon. Your starting right fielder is Eddie Miller, gives the Ospreys their sixth strikeout of the day, one out, and here's Dixon, who takes the ball. As now it looks like for UNF, it's Matthew Naylor out in the pen, and Naylor could come in. The last 2 years, he's gone at least 28 or 30 appearances on the year. The 1-0 pitch, and that one ripped over into left field. That's going to drop for a base hit, as Dalton Board will get that back into the infield, and so Dixon with another hit there. It's 18 hits today for College of Charleston. And it'll be a pinch hitter here, as they'll send in number four now, as Seth Wall will get his first at bat today. So Seth Wall comes in, usually a catcher, the junior comes on in for an at-bat. Spent a little bit of time before College of Charleston at Spartanburg Methodist College, as he doesn't swing and smartly takes a ball. 1-0 the count, as Wondrak will end his day and Wall will take over behind the plate. As Eddie Miller, the windup and the 1-0 pitch, and swing and a miss. And a strike there, 1-1. So it could be a chance that maybe we just see these guys for a few more pitches. Maybe Miller, maybe a couple more at-bats, and you get two more arms in for the Ospreys and get guys warmed up for conference play. One ball, one strike. Here's Wall. He'll swing. That one through the hole over to left field, and another base hit. So Wall with the base hit. Now 19 today for the Cougars. And it'll be another pinch hitter as Freeman comes in. So Ari Sakopoulos, who is right there, I'd probably split it for College of Charleston between Sakopoulos and Tommy Richter, because you've got one with the grand slam and one with four hits, but they definitely embody what College of Charleston has done here today. They lead 13-1. We're in the top of the eighth with two men on first and second. Zeddy Miller stares in. The lefty looks back at second. Now at the catcher. First pitch here and swings, and a nice one on the inside of the plate to get Xavier Freeman. The junior previously played at Seminole State College. Is a very good player at about 2 hours and 20 minutes of game time. Miller, the southpaw. The 0-1. Hart will swing. That one over to left field. That one back. Tracking it down is Dalton Board at the warning track. And tagging, and that'll be a sack fly there. And another run comes across to make it 16-1 with the Cougars leading. So back-to-back RBI at-bats for Dupree Hart, and he's had a good game also for this Cougars squad. So Knudsen comes in now, and another pinch hitter, number three, as that'll be it for Roper, is all nine starters with the hit today for College of Charleston, low and away, and there's ball one to Knudsen. Two outs with runners on first and third, as it's been 16 unanswered runs here today by the Cougars. The 1-0 pitch from Miller. Is that one a nice curveball there? As Knudsen, a junior, 6'3" and a 190, as he'll come in and take over the DH spot. The 1-1. And Miller doesn't get him to swing. Two balls and one strike. Eddie Miller will just have ball cap for the Ospreys. So we'll hopefully get them ready for the weekend, as we've had some good matchups this week. FGCU and Florida State earlier this week. UF and Stetson. Is that one low and away for another ball? As a two big weekend series with the count 3-1 against Riley Knudsen with runners first and third. FGCU will play in DeLand against Stetson. The 3-1 pitch inside, and there's a five-pitch walk. And so that's going to load the bases. And we'll go to Logan McRae. And McRae is somebody that, I mean, always home run ready. He's been on base today with just one hit, but, man, one of the best sluggers in the CAA. And his team has a 16-1 lead. Bases loaded, two outs. Just need to get McRae out, and he pops it up behind us. As it's been a strikeout to Tommy Richter on a close call. Otherwise, it'd probably just be one out and maybe another run or two coming across. The 0-1 pitch, McRae, curveball high and in that inside corner for strike two. So FGCU and Stetson, one of the big series this weekend. Dolphins surprising a lot of people as they took 2 of 3 from the Eagles down in Fort Myers. You have two pitch from Miller, and that one too low for ball one. as UNF will play at Lipscomb, and that's probably the real big series to watch. I want to see Stetson and a little bit more of their young pitching and what they're doing with the weekend rotation. As Miller gets set for the freshman, here comes a 1-2. McRae swings and misses, and two strikeouts there, but three more runs come across for College of Charleston. Cougars lead 16-1. We head to the bottom of the eighth here at Harmon Stadium as UNF will send up the top of the order, as it'll be Irvin, Thibodeau, and Garola right after this. It's UNF baseball on 1010 XL. Work a few changes in the field for College of Charleston as the Cougars lead 16-1. They've had now four frames with crooked numbers. Grand slam in the second inning. Two runs came across in that top of the fifth. Five-run frame in the sixth, and then a three-run eighth there. We're in the bottom of the eighth as North Florida will go Pat Irvin, Chris Thibodeau, and it looked like maybe Tanner Murphy as a DH. And that one over to right field is Irvin. That one back goes off the wall, that core digital sign, and there's going to be a double for Patrick Irvin. He'll slide in cleat high as Irvin, double number five on the year. So the Ospreys get their eighth hit of the day, and Patrick Irvin able to break that stretch of seven straight Ospreys retired. Changes in the field as Chris Thibodeau comes up to bat. 16-1, the Cougars lead. Bottom of the eighth with Irvin on second and missing there for a ball to start things off. Also want to give a shout out because tomorrow we've got UNF men's and women's tennis underway. The women will start things off, I guess maybe first toss. We'll call it first toss at 2 p.m. For the men's side, it'll be 6 p.m. against USC Upstate for both those squads against the Spartans. 1-0, Thibodeau will swing, and that one a ground ball. Takes a weird hop and off the glove of shortstop Luke Manzo and coming home to score. And it's going to be a hit and a run for the Ospreys as Irvin will make it 16-2 now. So Thibodeau with a four-hit game, and the Ospreys go back-to-back with a couple of hits. And Yair Garola comes out as Garola. It's just going to be his sixth game of the year without a hit. And here's Tanner Murphy for the Ospreys. Number 24, big guy, always walks by me, and I'm like, how old are you? You're like a foot taller than I am. No outs and a man on first. Murphy takes a strike. Alex Merritt on deck for North Florida. As UNF now with nine hits, two runs. On the other side, though, 20 hits and 16 runs for the Cougars. And really producing over the last week and a half. And getting some time called. Looked like the battery had a tough time putting together what they wanted to throw there. As UNF today, they've gone Bradford, Vaca, Polanski, Smith, Howes, and Miller, all going either an inning or two, an inning for Polanski, Smith, Howes, and Miller, the latter four. Charleston, as Murphy takes a ball there, almost was going for a big torque and a swing. But the Cougars started off with Griffin McLarty. He went two innings, giving up four hits and just the one run as he's in line for his first collegiate win. And then it was Detweiler who went two and a third. Clay Hunt went an inning and two-thirds. And Trent Ryder in his second inning of work as he's gone a full inning and a strike. There is number two to Tanner Murphy. Ryder so far giving up two hits and the one run, both coming in this inning. As he's just over 15 pitches. A count one and two for Murphy. With no outs, it's bottom of the eighth. And Murphy reaches, and Ryder, the great pitch almost in the dirt. And here's Alex Merritt. As Murphy is retired for the first out. So the Ospreys were able to open up this inning. Back-to-back hits, a double by Irvin. An RBI single by Chris Thibodeau off the glove of shortstop Luke Manzo. And Merritt now looking for his second hit. He's got a 10-game hit streak. And he'll take a strike there here at Harmon Stadium. Remember, the Ospreys, they'll be gone from home for a little bit with Lipscomb on the road, but we'll be back for a Thursday, Friday, Saturday due to Easter Sunday. Thursday, Friday, Saturday here at Harmon Stadium next week. The 0-1 pitch from Ryder popped up, and Merritt, that's going to stay in the infield as Manzo will keep the eyes to the sky and get out number two. So Merritt is retired there, and it'll be a pinch hitter as Chris Mathias. So Merritt flies out. Chris Berry, his day will be over, but continues his stretch because he got a single. So it's 19 straight games where he's been on base safely for Chris Berry. So here's Mathias with two outs and a man on, and takes ball one. Ospreys with a couple of arms out in the pen at the moment, as it also looks like Trace Nork is getting warmed up with Matthew Naylor. Mathias here, the matchup against Ryder. One ball, no strikes. With two outs and a man on, there's ball number two outside. As both Ryder and Hunt going for an inning and two-thirds each, combining to give up three hits and just one run. The Ospreys breaking that stretch of 16 unanswered runs. They got the run by Patrick Irvin because of that leadoff double. The 2-0, and Mathias swings and misses. So Mathias will sweat off that forehead with the batting helmet and get that fit just right. Here against Ryder with the count. Two balls and one strike as Mathias is eighth at-bat this year. He'll take a cut again. A high fastball, now 2-2. Mathias this year, batting average of 143. Only the sixth appearance he's had this year, as he's got a run and a hit to his name. Two balls, two strikes with two outs. We sit in the bottom of the eighth with the Ospreys trailing 16-2. Mathias takes one on the outside of the plate for a full count. So the Ospreys going with their fourth pinch hitter today in a game where they've been able to get nine hits, two of them coming in this inning alone, and their second run as well coming here. Full count. The man on first. The runner goes. Mathias hits that to center field, and it'll be there for Luke Morgan for out number three. So the Ospreys able to get two hits and a run across. Thibodeau, another RBI, and we head to the top of the ninth with College of Charleston leading 16-2 over North Florida. We'll take a break and come on back here to Harmon Stadium. You're tuned in to UNF Baseball. It's the Ospreys Sports Network. It's the Osprey Sports Network as we sit here, top of the ninth, and North Florida trails College of Charleston 16-2. Also, an update as well because of maybe some high winds that are predicted. It's kind of windy right now, but it's going to pick up tomorrow. Women's tennis tomorrow will be moved to 9 a.m. So maybe if you have an afternoon class, get out there and support the UNF women's tennis squad as they are really good in conference play. 9 a.m. start time. It was originally 2, so make sure you get out there. You know, what do they say? It's something about the morning sun that you really need to, like, start your day. You know, get a good base tan. Or if you're like me in college, you just sleep in until, like, 11:30. Catch the Price is Right. Maybe eat breakfast. Trace Norick is now out for the Ospreys. He'll look to finish off this game for UNF and keep the bats in check for the Cougars. As we'll see if we get any new bats back out there. And it looks to be the same with Tommy Richter leading off this ninth inning. Struck out in the eighth. He's got 4 hits today. 3 singles and a triple. 19 hits already for College of Charleston. Make it 20. Is that one into center field? And Norcus, last time we saw him was about a week ago, is against Bethune-Cookman for the sophomore, who stands at 6'2" and about 200 pounds, maybe a few more pounds over, 202, 201. But he was at Bethune-Cookman. Actually, that was a game here, went for 2 innings as he struck out 1, also walked a pair on 36 pitches. And so Bradley Dixon. Now for College of Charleston, though, we've got ourselves a bench hitter. I forgot Mundy came in to be in right field. So Mundy with his first at-bat. As Mundy trying to get another base hit this year for Joey Mundy. I like that name. It just kind of rolls off the tongue. His parents did well in naming him, I must say. As he hits that one to center field, and Thibodeau's going to be there in left center for out number 1. His good name does not impress Thibodeau enough to give him another base hit. 16-2 as College of Charleston leads this one, and Seth Wall will be up for another at-bat. He had a single back in the eighth inning and taking over the catcher duties today for Danny Wondrak. With one out and a man on over first, as Norcus gets ready here. He's not giving up an earned run since the 11th of March. And her ball too low for ball 1. 2 arms in the pen currently for the Cougars. Might go with one or the other. The Ospreys, same thing. They've got 2 arms out there where whatever the scenario might provide. As we get a little bit of shade here at the ballpark, the 1-0 pitch from Norcus. That one down the third baseline, blocked by Merritt. He's going to barehand it, not have a play. And that's going to be error number 2 on Alex Merritt over at third base. So the A-Sun Player of the Week, a tough fielding day for him, as one ball went through his legs, and that ball went off his chest, and Xavier Freeman is second at bat, as he's got 2 men on first and second with 1 out in the top of the ninth. So here's Freeman. After getting hit by a pitch on that right foot, he takes one too far inside for a ball. College of Charleston looking for win number 14, as it would also just be their 4th win away from home. As 1-0 pitch, and Freeman finds a hole. He's got a hit today, and the second time he'll be on base. And again, College of Charleston loads of bases as they lead 16-2, top of the ninth, with 1 out. And here's Luke Morgan. So Morgan for a bit there. I mean, we were talking about him in the 4th, 5th, and top of the 6th inning, saying, man, this guy is not doing all that much. He was 0 for 2, but he's got a single, double, and reaching on an error since then. With bases loaded, Norkus, that one gets fouled off. It'll be, got a little bit of the wiring on that light fixture. That was kind of cool. Although the cars have been avoided today after Saturday was just brutal to some sunroofs and a cop car. And was it a Toyota Corolla? Did we figure there was maybe a VW of some kind? Circa 08. The 0-1 pitch from Norkus. There's a curveball well inside, but gets a strike called. The count 0-2 to Luke Morgan. So five Cougars. You know, this stood out to me when doing my homework over the last couple days. The fact that they had five of them this year with an on-base streak of 11 games or more. They've got multiple guys that can do it. The 0-2, and that one into right center field. So that's going to be a base hit, and that's going to be a couple of bags under the glove of Chris Thibodeau out to the warning track. And so three runs are going to come across, and you clear the bases to make it 19-2 now in the top of the ninth. So he takes an 0-2 pitch to right center field. And Luke Morgan, man, I might have to put him up there with Zacopoulos and who is Tommy Richter. Man, those guys had really good games. So we're back to the top of the order with a 22-hit game. And it's 19-2 with leadoff man. Three singles today for Luke Manzo. So six hits this year against UNF, as he has definitely consistently played the best against the Ospreys. The 1-0 pitch from Norkus, too far inside, two balls and no strikes. So the Ospreys today throw out a multitude of pitchers, as they're on their seventh pitcher right now. Norkus giving up three hits and three runs. That one gets fouled off now, 2-1. So Norkus needing these two more outs, and the coaching staff putting the young sophomore in a tough position, but this is definitely how you get better, and down the line you're able to focus in on an A-Sun tournament game. The 2-1 from Norkus and Manco, that one to left field. Good play there by Dalton Board. They're not going to test the arm there as they get it in to Alex Merritt. And there's two outs. And Luke Manco retired with his third fly ball of the afternoon. And here comes Dupree Hart. I tell you what, I think if I'm drafting a team of CAA squads, I mean, UNCW's got some good players. Hofstra, they've got maybe one or two that I'd like to build a team around, but Dupree Hart as a second baseman, I mean, nothing's getting by him. Here's with two outs and a man on third, he takes a strike looking. His Hart today with a couple of runs knocked in his last two at-bats, three runs over the weekend, as he was preseason all-conference at second base, and I think that's going to be for the next 3 years. He's locked down that spot. The 0-1, and that one's going to be a slow roller to second. Joe Boyle, that one, he's unable to make the play there. And the Ospreys with another error, as the Ospreys with five errors today, as Joe Boyle usually over at third base, as not sure what happened to that ball exactly, if maybe Dupree Hart hit it to where it kind of unraveled a little bit, but they sent that back to the dugout. I'll try and figure out what that is for the post-game show. Remember to stick around for that. About 15 minutes or so after the game of coverage. Two outs and men on. Actually, just the one after they're able to play the man on third. 20-2 with the Cougars leading. And here's Riley Knudsen again. As he walked back in the eighth, Trace Norkus and swing and a miss there and a strike for Knudsen, the lefty bat. As Norkus now just needing that one out as the bullpens have kind of calmed down. It looks like for College of Charleston, they'll go with the righty to finish off the bottom of the ninth. But There has been runs scored in every inning except the fourth and the first for College of Charleston. They have plated now 15 runs over the last five innings. As Norcus stares in, Knudsen, two balls and one strike. Hard on over at first base, and Norcus, there's a pitch well inside. And really making Chris Mathias work for that pitch there. So Norcus here, three balls and one strike. Keep something on the ground, make it easy on your infield. As Knudsen will take a five-pitch walk, and so Knudsen reaching twice today, a pair of walks. And it'll be cleanup man Logan McRae. So College of Charleston not quite ready to go back to South Carolina. As they lead 20-2 over the Ospreys in this four-run ninth inning, two outs. And with a runner on first, a runner on second, McRae swings and misses strike one. As he was ready to golf swing that out to deep right center. McRae, just a redshirt freshman, coming in hitting 354. He also has eight home runs. Norcus, the 0-1 pitch, and that one low in the zone as McRae was like, not so sure about that right there. As Norcus jumps ahead 0-2. Today, multiple hits for Morgan as well. Wondrak, Dixon, Richter, and Manzo. 22 hits for the Cougars. The 0-2 pitch, McRae will strike out looking as he'll kick his bat. And College of Charleston will strand runners first and second. We head to the bottom of the ninth as it looks like a few field changes here for the Cougars. And North Florida will send up, it looks like, the bottom of the order, but changes could be made in the lineup. College of Charleston 20, North Florida 2, bottom of the ninth, upcoming here, Harmon Stadium. It's UNF Baseball on the Osprey Sports Network. Osprey Sports Network from UNF's Harmon Stadium. It's been a beautiful day on campus. It feels like it's kind of cooled down a little bit. The breeze is still there, but, I mean, you talk about Northeast Florida, it's always humid. It doesn't always feel that way. So we'll finish things off with Tucker White for College of Charleston. As White, a junior, 6'2 and 225. And something I noticed with almost every pitching player for the Cougars, I mean, they've got stellar prep careers, as he was great in Oklahoma, and we start with the strike to Dalton Board. The Ospreys here with Board, also that'll be James Fitzpatrick as he's on deck. You know, one pitch, and that one over to left field is moving in, and that'll be caught there in left by Freeman. So Xavier Freeman records a first out, and Dalton Board retired there, his second at-bat of the game. And James Fitzpatrick for the Ospreys. As Fitzpatrick, his sixth game of the year, it'll be his fifth at-bat. He's scored a run, but looking for his first hit of 2017. With one out, bottom of the ninth, and there's a strike from Tucker White. Is White playing high school baseball in Oklahoma, going 10-0 one season, an ERA of 0.50. The 0-1, here it comes from White, and swings on a high fastball. Fitzpatrick falls behind 0-2. Christian Diaz on deck for the Ospreys, as UNF with 9 hits today, trailing College of Charleston 20-2 in this bottom of the ninth. White looks in, almost covering his whole face with the glove. I mean, can barely see his eyes. I think he's looking through the stitching in between his mitt. Here comes the 0-2 from White and Fitzpatrick. Oh, close there. One ball and two strikes. As today for the Cougars, they've gone also with a number of pitchers. They've gone McLarty for two innings, two and a third for Detweiler. Hunt went an inning and two-thirds. Two innings for Ryder, as White will finish off this inning. And Fitzpatrick, that one is back. Back and at the wall, that one is yard. There and out of the ballpark as the Ospreys, James Fitzpatrick. Oh, my goodness. And his fifth at bat, that is his first hit as an Osprey. So UNF makes it 20-3. And James Fitzpatrick, one of the few highlights today for the Ospreys. And many UNF fans won't remember April 5th of 2017, but I can tell you Fitzpatrick will definitely remember this date. So here's Christian Diaz for the Ospreys, UNF first baseman. So he takes high and inside for a ball. The Ospreys have gone back-to-back innings with a run now, but those five errors just looking at me, and I just stop it. Stop it, scoreboard. 1-0 pitch, Diaz. With a strike, as Diaz 0-3 today. And for the Ospreys, behind him, it'll be Joe Boyle putting on his batting gloves right now. One ball, one strike. Here's Tucker White as Diaz ground ball hard to Dupree. Gloves at the play at first, and pretty routine for Dupree Hart. Two outs in this bottom of the ninth as Joe Boyle comes up for the Ospreys. As Boyle had an at-bat in that sixth inning. So two at-bats today, and he's trying to get out of a little bit of a funk for himself, as I think it'd be his first hit in his last maybe 11 at-bats. So here's Boyle, a strike on the inside of the plate to the righty Boyle. Number 10, he took over at second base and also has an error today. No balls, one strike. As Tucker White, the windup, and a strike again, 0-2. With two outs in the bottom of the ninth, the Cougars lead 20-3 over the Ospreys. And some major revenge for that 11-2 loss at home at the hands of UNF. Here's Boyle, swings at that, chopped into the ear, just past the COC dugout. Remember, this weekend we won't be on radio for the Lipscomb series. However, the Bisons will have ESPN3 for Friday and Sunday. The 0-2, here's White, Boyle. That one will be to the glove of the third baseman. And that throw will be late. And Joe Boyle with the hit. So he gets out of his little funk and he gets his 11th hit of the year. That's great for Joe Boyle. You know, that had been in my notes for just way too long, as he'll finish 1-for-2 today, but his last hit was back on March 18th. And that makes me feel good. James Fitzpatrick, a solo home run, and also Joe Boyle, a hit today, gets out of a little mini slump. And here's leadoff man Patrick Irvin for the Ospreys. He had that double to start off the eighth inning, with two outs and the Ospreys trailing 20-3. It's the Ospreys Sports Network, as you can always check out the baseball team on Twitter at Osprey BSB. One ball, no strikes for Patrick Irvin. Is that sun getting a little bit lower? Also, congrats to the Armada. 1-0 victory over at Hodges. That one ripped down the right field line. Oh, it'll be foul, as Patrick Irvin almost had a couple of doubles there. Count 1-1 as he'll tighten up the batting gloves left and right, then fix that, adjust that little padding on the right elbow. And then lick the forefinger and middle finger of his batting glove, which I've done that before. It just does not taste good. I don't get the routine, personally. So Boyle's on first. Count 1-1 with two outs. A 17-run lead for the Cougars. As Tucker White, here the third pitch to Irvin. There's low for a ball as Seth Wall kind of dropped it there and stared at it. Just daring Joe Boyle to take second. Chris Thibodeau on deck for the Ospreys. We've got a few UNF volleyball players here at Harmon Stadium watching the action. The 2-1 pitch. There's going to be a strike to even things up at 2-2 for Patrick Irvin. Today, the one hit, a double. So he's got 7 hits over his last 4 games. And really, I mean, you need that leadership and that setting of an example for these younger players going into weekend number 2 of A-Sun play. The 2-2 to Irvin. And that one's going to find the hole over in the right field for another base hit. And the Ospreys with 12 hits today. And back-to-back base runners for North Florida. So the Ospreys here stay alive with 2 outs and trailing 20-3. And I don't know if my voice is ready for a 17-run comeback. I don't know if I might need a few pitching changes to get back in this, but you bring up Chris Thibodeau, who scored the first run of the game with that solo shot in the bottom of the first. And here's Tucker White. That one over to right field. It's going to be down the line and foul as that one hits the wall. And my goodness, if he comes across a little bit quicker, that's a 3-run home run. I've seen crazy things happen. 17 runs would definitely be nuts. Is that bus just did stall out there? Did you see that? At about 420 from us or so, from home plate. Oh, no, it looked like it stopped. It held up a few cars. No balls and one strike. The Ospreys runners first and second. Here's Tucker White as Thibodeau takes a ball 1-1. Another close pitch there. White stares in. A combined 34 hits this afternoon. The 1-1. Here's Thibodeau. He won't swing and takes another ball. 2 balls and 1 strike for Chris Thibodeau. Today has gotten a hit in every at-bat. Only his second 4-hit game of the season. As Thibodeau gets ready to go, a unanimous selection for the All-A-Sun. The 2-1, Thibodeau, a strike there, 2-2. Bottom of the ninth with College of Charleston leading 20-3. Check out UNFOspreys.com for all your game recaps, whether it's UNF baseball or softball or even tennis and track and field. The 2-2, Thibodeau won't swing. He'll strike out looking, and that'll end the game as College of Charleston will split the season series with North Florida as the Cougars win 20-3 here at Harmon Stadium. The Ospreys won back in the middle of March, 11-2. We'll take a break and come on back. We'll get your box score and game recap here on 1010XL and wrap things here up and put a bow on everything over the next 10-15 minutes as you're tuned in. Post-game show a few moments away. It's the Osprey Sports Network.